reviewing that show. We're here to review that show. And if you think we can't, we can still review that show. All the people be trying to view like us, but no, we can't. It's Marty, Marty, and...
J.Steel!
And that's it.
Oh yeah, but nigga basically invited me and Jess to be in this film together or whatever. But like, I'm reading information and I was gonna get back to him because I'm like, okay, you know, I ain't doing nothing. I'd buy the check and see what I'm doing that weekend, but I don't think I'm doing nothing that weekend. But I didn't really rush to get back to them because I had to take in, wait, I don't know if I know you, like, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. I'm not too sure who you are messaging me. And we was caught up in the rapture of the freaking 48 that I'm like, look, I see this long ass message that you sending me, homie. I gotta go do this thing I'm doing for these 2 days. I'll get back to you. Now Jesse just messaged me and said, such and such got at me, and then she told me who the guy was and reminded me of you know, a film that he directed that I really dug.
Oh shit.
See, you breaking shit. You got on my girl glasses, like, not even taking, not even asking me who they for. That's not mine. So if you break them, you better be buying J. Steel another fucking pair of glasses. Dog. And you just busted my freaking mask. Touching shit. That's what happens when you invite Mike5 to doing that show, you heard me? That's what happens. Shit in your house get broken.
That's what happens when you go to your brother's crib, bro. You try on stuff, dog.
You got to. You got to see if it fit my head.
Man, all that, man.
Y'all niggas just talking to the side, man. You wasn't even supposed to be paying attention to me, my nigga.
Impossible, son.
He's like, I'm here, I'm involved.
There's a whole body to my left, nigga. And it's not J.Steel and Marty. I was just to my right, so I'm going to know this should be in here. Welcome to the Reviewing Dat Show, man.
Oh, we was recording?
We always recording, bro.
Oh, I feel you, though. That's why I was putting the glasses on. I was trying to get in my zone, be myself.
I mean, hey, son, however you got to do it, you got to do it, man. Shouts out to y'all, man. This is that actor guy, Mr. Bass, in the building. We're in this thing for a special Reviewing Dat Show. You hear me? We're not going to be talking movies and TV and reviews like we normally do. We're about to review a goddamn experience. As you already heard, we've been talking about for some months now that, you know, we do the 48-hour film project and competition, dog.
Oh, yeah.
You feel me? I mean, you know, we always talk about it.
Yeah.
And then last year, of course, we had to reviewing that 48 podcast. You know, man, this is going to be the second one. It's looking pretty annual, man. So before we get into all
we'll
that.
We'll see. I got to tell my story first. We'll see if it's an annual
thing. God. Oh shit! Let him know who you is. Shit, let's go.
Oh man, yeah, I got some shit. Story, because I'm in my head right now, man. I just want to get this off my chest now, because I don't know where this is gonna end up.
Oh god.
Oh man, it's like
what sleep. A hook.
Sleep is an interesting thing, dude. You without it, you a different person. Anyway, this is your favorite host, Marty, M-A-R-T-Y.
Hold on, let Fred Savage get moving.
I thought you said come up the alleyway.
Ain't nobody come up the alleyway.
Oh, that was just
outside? That's outside in the front.
Damn.
What you mean?
Like, whoa. He's just on the street right now.
That's Fred Zappa rolling by, but go ahead,
Zappa. He got his cart and stuff. His favorite host, Marty here. M-A-R-T-Y. Edwards 504 on Instagram, Twitter, and Snapchat. Go to LorianPictures.com. Click on the Your30 tab. Like, rate, share. Give us a comment on our iTunes feed, and we will read it on the show. Yeah, all that good stuff.
All of that good stuff. Apparently, though, I hear it in your voice, you ain't the same man you was about 72 hours ago.
Nah, yeah, actually, you seem happy. Like, yeah, dog, I just want to talk about the screenwriting process. My nigga.
I do want to talk about that, but I'm like, yeah, this other stuff, man. I just got to get a temperature on it real quick. Hit it? I thought you wanted to
introduce yourself. Let him know who you are.
I didn't know who was introducing and he was going to run his story.
I was buried the lead, right? Like, oh man, we got to hear this shit now.
But what up, world, man? It's DJ Mike5, man. World famous bass mentality, you know what I mean? Holding it down like it's never really been held. I guess I'm a filmmaker, though, too. Like, and father and DJ. I be kicking
my nigga
pants.
Don't know if you're a filmmaker. He don't know if you're a father. He said, I guess, you know?
Yeah, I do a lot of things, but like my children right now are like stealing all my creative juice. But I guess, you know, you can see me sometimes at Mike_5IVE. You know what I mean? You know, if you listen for like hip hop, I'm Friday 12 to 2, WTL New Orleans, bitch.
Yeah, man, that's what he meant by bass mentality, man. That's the name of my dog show. Was that did you bring that mug here?
Yeah.
What does that say? Oh. My son came here with a mug.
My nephew got me this.
Oh, this is cool. Civil rights from the Birmingham Institute.
All
right.
That's all they really got, so they trying to make it tourism.
Oh, so you made, but you made the mug an ashtray. I thought you came here. I thought you had something in there.
Boy,
been like,
I did. Did I? Yeah, like I did.
He came with his own hot chocolate. He about to get up.
It's an illusion. I'm like, yeah, that's how I roll now.
With the bug. My own personal hot.
You come with your own personal bugs. My seeds is for the ash. I was about to laugh. Like, damn, my nigga, you gonna pull out the pipe? My nigga's refined. You know, Danzel, funny enough, we had a nigga on our squad named Danzel Square. Shouts out to Danzel, man. Cool, super cool cat. He let us use one of his rooms for location. He's also an actor. He one of them cats that's like, whatever you need, I'm here to help. I love people like that in game. Yeah. When we do this type of shit.
He right. About it.
He has a one of those refined pipes, like old school.
Oh, like he does like the green out of it?
He put the weed in there too. Okay, yeah, but I laughed when he pulled it out. Now, like, son, a pipe? Not even like, because most smokers know, like, you know, you might, if you smoke weed out of a pipe, what a weed pipe looks like. Yeah. No, nigga, this was a pipe. Like, you see that with the curve, the bell, and the J, like a fucking J and shit.
You sit there and puff on that mug for a little bit.
You gotta feel a bit regal. I feel like I can't even smoke out that pipe unless I, like get the ham. The mustache, dog.
The handlebar.
I feel like, if I've got the handlebar, I need not have the original pipe.
Fair enough. Nah.
But yeah,
it's retro.
I mean, it's super retro. I ain't mad at them. Do your thing.
Yeah.
But welcome to the show, y'all, man. We about to talk 48 Hour Film Project, man. We both had teams. We was on separate teams, as we do, representing the black side of things for that joint. You heard me? But people
same
that
group for the first time.
Oh, we're in the same screening. We were never in the same screening. Never. This time we're in the fucking same screening. Mm-hmm. And for the people that don't know, it might be your first time listening. Every episode, someone's first time. The 48 Hour Film Project is a competition where they give you 2 days to create a 7-minute film. They give you a line of dialogue that must be in your movie. They give you a prop. They don't give you the prop, but they tell you what prop you got to have that has to be in your movie. Right. And there's a character who always has some kind of very specific job that, like, whether it's like a teacher, this year was an accountant, right. That has to be in your movie. Those are the elements. Once you get, they give you the elements after, you know, well, we'll get into that, but they give you the elements, and you have to pick a genre from a hat or a bucket or a bowl or whatever the hell you're picking them joints out from, and whatever genre you get, you get two, and you get to choose one, the other, or mix them up. And you go from there. You give you know, the 2 days, you got to make the damn movie. And you got to turn it in on time, and it got to follow all the directions, et cetera, et cetera. All right?
Like
so,
on paperless with they bitch ass.
Yeah. Oh, that's a whole other thing. So, so you know, us over here with Team Gumbo Monster, man, we've been doing that joint here in New Orleans since its inception, since the very one. Since the very first one.
How many still had FEMA trailers?
Oh, wow.
Because it started right after Katrina.
So how many is that for y'all?
This would be 13 now.
13. Okay. Yeah.
Now, we weren't always Team Gumbo Monster doing it.
Oh, really? Okay.
We've gone through different names.
What was the first name y'all did it under?
I don't know. Probably our name, but we, like, after that, we started calling ourselves Ragtag, but that didn't stick.
Okay.
We was with Cult of One for a second.
No, but I wasn't, no. We did a film with a Cult of One. That's different. Okay. I don't remember, like, what our name was for the first few. I don't remember.
I'm telling you, we was Ragtag at one point.
No, I know we were Ragtag at one point. Son, look what you're saying.
But it was distinctively something. No, well, he said that initially in the beginning, y'all just did it under y'all name, but you remember it being something distinct more
No, it's not that I remember that. What I'm saying is I don't remember. I remember Ragtag. I remember doing that one film where we did one of them with a Cult of One, and I remember eventually becoming Gumbo Monster. Uh-huh. But, like, because if I look at it, like, our very first year we did it, Five came up to me. He found this freaking flyer or some shit, and he was like, some shit he wanted to do.
On the internet.
And he was he was.
What was it like in the very, very beginning?
Well, I'm about to run it
to
you.
I'm sorry, yeah.
No, I'm going to let you know, son. But, like, I remember, and, like, Five had just, you know, he was going to Tulane at the time. Mm-hmm. And that was the access. He had the cameras and was already, like, you know, I guess experimenting. I won't call it film class, but it was a film class, but they didn't really call it that.
The chicks over at the Newcomb Art Media had a grant for women and girls to document their experience, so they had cast it by EQ. I took a class, and that gave me...
But what was the class? I was saying, what class gave you that access to the cameras? Because whatever that class was gave us them Tulane access for some years. Before we got our own cameras, bitch, Tulane camera department. What's that media?
Newcomb Art Center.
Bitch, they would lend us them cameras. I don't even think Mike was even in school no more. We still was getting them bitches.
It was like some women's theorize. I was in class with number chicks talking about movies, but like chick movies and theory. So like a women's theories class about filmmaking.
How did you fall into this class?
Nigga, be on the thing.
Like, you know, when you flip through the list of, like,
Yeah.
Oh, in the catalog?
Yeah, I understand that, but that, I personally, I'm not trying to be sexist. I know I wouldn't have picked that class of all the classes to go to.
Were there, like, a lot of options?
Like, right. Was that the only film? Like, there's no other
place. No disrespect. Okay, we get into a disrespectful place now. Hold on.
I feel what you're saying.
It's not my first one to go, like, yo.
Yeah.
No joke. I mean, but I learned a lot, though, like, because looking at how, like, other filmmakers think about, like, Maya Darren or whatever, Frankenstein is
No, pause. Don't start giving me the merit of I understand the merit of the class. What me and Marty are trying to ask you is what made 20-year-old Mike5 randomly say, because there's other film classes, there's other classes
that were there not?
I think
maybe they weren't.
Maybe they weren't. Because I wouldn't take Mike5 to be the nigga to say class number one, women's theories in film class. I just don't see that on you at 20.
I'm not.
No, pause. It is not sexist to be your friend, known you since I was 12 years old, and ask why, out of all knowing you, of all the classes,
I wouldn't know that.
What made you, Mike5, choose women in theory? And I will still piggyback on this with you, Marty. I have not known you as long.
Right.
Like, I would ask any of my niggas if a man comes to me and he doesn't seem like one of them cats that's like wearing I'm a female feminist shirt on my fucking you know what I mean, picture on my damn shirt. You know what I mean? He just walked up to me and said, "Yeah, dog, I was in women theories in film class when I was a freaking junior." Right. I'm a be curious and be like, "Oh, what made you choose that one?" You know what I mean? Was it part of the curriculum?
What brought you around to that idea?
Or was it something that you was interested in coming in? I'm going to be curious to that, because I'm like, damn, you a nigga that off the dump was interested in that. I'm curious. Yeah. Or was it a class you were stuck with and it just had no others? I want to take film, but all other film classes that they only had like 3 film classes available. So if I wanted to take some film, I had to jump in that bitch. Because I would jump in that bitch. I mean, I said I wouldn't take the fucking class. It's just funny that if it was your number one, I want to know how and why.
Man, really, dog? Like, on college shit, dog, I think it was about time.
20-year-old niggas? We talking 10 years ago. We ain't talking this now shit, nigga. Yeah.
But I think it's about, I probably picked up the class about the time, but I didn't learn about the grant shit till I got in the class.
No,
like,
no, see, now you're not answering the question. He ran over to answer the question.
Come on, you're not gonna let
dog, I think I just picked that bitch at random, because, like, as we talk about it, that shit, it's an elective, so it's only, it occurs randomly. So I was just like, man, fuck it, it fit the slot, let's take it.
So you needed a time, you need a class in that time slot.
Yeah.
And see now.
Okay.
I mean, but it's still on the sheet of being like a choice.
Yeah, but what were the other choices?
Probably some white shit.
That was the most attractive option. Like, you chose that out of
like
out
to
of
just
others.
To go back on some school and shit. Like, once you really like, you take an intro to film class, and then all other film classes are the same besides film theory. Like, in a way, like film theory and intro. The intro one is like, if you can sit through this, all right, you on the road. Film theory, when you take that bitch, nigga, you eat so like nigga, we ate Wizard of the Oz from every aspect. Like, I'm about to get this bitch. Like, then, like, talking about Freud and dream analysis. I'm about to eat this shit. So, you taking big chunks. Like, what's a normal movie like that niggas like that's like a classic Hollywood movie that y'all like?
Godfather.
Man, we ate that bitch from top to bottom, nigga. Whipped it up, then regurgitated that shit.
That's what film theory is for.
Yeah,
that's
what I'm saying. Like,
I mean, we're not eating that bitch.
It's a lot of, like, heavy stuff. So I was, like, probably wanting to, like, switch up or change. So I was like, women in film. All right, let's see what's happening with the chicks. And then, like, from that, though, it gives you, like, interesting viewpoints. And, like, I don't know. I guess this sounds sexist, but bitches think about, like, film different. So it's, like, interesting.
Are you wondering why I asked Mike that question? Are you wondering now? Are you clear?
No.
My nigga just said, bitches think about film different. God. And you wonder why I'm asking him. Damn, you took a woman's
class. And I was going to say, before you gave me that last one, I was going to say, you know what? I do remember being in a similar position in my academic years.
But bitches think about film different.
It's like this.
Excuse me. Female
is not the word.
It's too late. No.
But from
there's
that,
nothing wrong with the first phrase.
Boy, about it,
it's
my,
just funny as shit.
When we was on set, he said something about the broad. And I said, Mike, what the broad? What are we in the 1940s? Hey, she ain't a broad and the dames over there.
Man, I don't give a fuck about fictional people. I feel like I could call you anything. You know what I mean? Like that bitch over there. Man, stand in your place.
But character.
Like, yeah, I'm not really addressing you as a human. I'm like, you know, right
now. Well, no, kid, this is getting muddy. He didn't address anyone, actual human being, as a broad. But it's just funny that he pulled out this old term. We talk about some, you know, we're talking about story and a female character. And I'm like, the broad, for real, Mike, the broad.
You know,
those, those bitches look at movies different, don't they? Oh, but I want to say, duh, nigga. Every, like, men and women look at life differently, so why wouldn't their art come from a different perspective than that you're used to being a man? That's what's supposed to happen.
I learned radical stuff.
I'm like, glad you did. I'm glad you did, dog. I will always say that the merit in the class don't have to be explained. Yeah, women's theories, hell yeah. Women, let me see what your theory is. Because me being a man, I can't know your shit. Just like I wish more white people took some African and some black shit. Because you don't know what the fuck we be on. Just like I feel like every straight person needs to sit in a room with a bunch of gay people and let them talk. I feel like any group that's not the freaking loved or the norm, that's freaking ostracized or oppressed in any manner in our country, if there's a way to get some insight on how they feel about shit, everybody on the opposite end should be required to listen. Straight up and down. So again, women, go see that shit. I just laughed. I was like, damn, because I never asked them how. I thought you got the cameras off your film theory class. And I thought it was just some like other film elective that you just took. And I even though we would go into the women's building to get the cameras, I'm just like, oh, this must just be where these cameras are that they're allowing to let him hold.
Man,
but the women's building?
The Newcomb Media Arts Building is specifically for
the women.
The women.
Oh, wow. Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
It's like a women library. Like, they really...
all the books in there was like women.
Like, writers. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh, wow.
It was cool as shit.
Oh, that's interesting.
But Tulane University is so big. Yeah, I just felt like, well, you know what I mean? The women probably, this little building is probably just the cool people. And they just like saying that this little black nigga just hold his cash down as long as he get it back good.
You know, we trust him.
We trust him.
He always
him.
Brings it back.
Something about him just,
I mean,
trust.
It was like that. I probably still have keys. I kind of forgot the
he had keys.
Yeah.
And this is the women's building and this man.
I mean, once they give you the keys in the combo, baby, you good.
But yeah. Bitches be looking at that movies differently.
It's okay, we trust him.
The people that really be on it.
Why you always been doing this? Why you been doing this, nigga? Like, this is you.
Fuck
this
that.
Is always you, nigga.
There's no safe words on the
phone. There's no safe words.
It was taught by my professor, Betsy Weiss, who's like a big person at the college fucking, I don't even have the word. What is it when you're a college professor, but you with your cohorts? What the fuck that circle's called? Whatever. Academia. I mean, she's a person known amongst academia or whatever, but she's also a filmmaker. So she was showing us like these weird ass movies. Like, it was like this chick being followed by this dude in a cloak with a mask. Man, I thought this shit was bullshit, dog. But like, when you sit back and read the critical writing on this shit, I'm like, bitch, what? Like, it's some shit like, it's mind fuckery. You know what I mean? But a nigga videotaped it for you. And then like, on top of that would be like, man, that's the struggle of a girl trying to get dressed. And you would be like, nigga, that's bullshit. Now, then when you go back and you look at it from that perspective, certain shit that I like, not because I don't get dressed as a woman, but I haven't had that experience or like, you know, taking that experience and making that shit artsy, you'd be like, oh, that's what's up or whatever. Or to be different, to make it to be more unilateral for people. Like, have you ever seen Salvador Dali? Like he cuts the moon, like he sees a cloud pass by the moon and then he cuts his girlfriend's eye open. And then like ants come out the palm of his hand.
This is sexy. Shit.
Nah, this is just like all like kind of like trippy ass like imagery that he created. Like when you read the writings about it, it kind of painted better for you to kind of understand it. So then you could like really see it. So it's like she threw me on some new shit to just be like, take your mind over here. And that's what the class was really about. Like
that's what it's for. So that's what you keep selling the merit of the class. And I keep saying, I understand.
We're reminiscing
the,
now.
The rhyme of the merit of the class.
Cool. Yeah. I'm just saying like, even though saying that you've never seen Salvador Dali is like, man, boom, you should probably go check it because that shit might add something to your like shit that you ain't never even thought about.
Word.
Or like connect some thought that you had. Like, you know what I mean? Saying other niggas
and
do it.
And that's what I'm saying.
Okay.
You need to do. We need to have a women's in film. We need to have a people of color, minorities, a black people in the film. We need to have gay. Like, I'm telling you, son, because even on the topic, like we talk about this when we was doing our film, because our film had a a slightly, we had an LGBT element at one point of the film, you feel me?
Okay.
And I was just, when me and Mike were just talking about like just that topic within film and within, you know, how just like even with this, being an American, you're taught to be racist, you're taught to be sexist, you're taught to be homophobic from jump.
Okay.
All men are taught this, all women are taught this, all straight people are gay people. That's why you got gay people who hate gay people, women who hate women, and don't even realize that they are against their own, what's good for them. Because it's the conditioning of our country many times to have us in these ways mentally. And we have, as we grow up and we grow and we have experiences and we have empathy and we, you know what I mean, stretch, we get these shackles of fuckery out of our system, out of our brain. But it's an ongoing thing, you know what I mean? For to be a straight man in this country and to not be sexist is unlearning a lot. To be straight man and not be homophobic is unlearning a lot. To be a white person born in fucking Wisconsin and not be racist or have something racist about you, unconscious or conscious, because that's the thing. A lot of white people get defensive as if we just call it them racist when we got it, when we try to get you to understand a lot of that shit that y'all do that's racist. Y'all, not enough of us understand this, but I will say this.
That they don't understand.
That they don't even see it because it's so normal. If your normal day is walk outside and you see a purple sky, if a nigga tell you the sky ain't supposed to be purple, no. You looking at that nigga gonna argue him down because you saw it be purple for 10, 15 years of your fucking life.
Like the mental acceptance of oh shit, I didn't realize that. But then, like some people's minds break or they live in denial about it.
Oh yeah,
too.
It's you there.
Know, so it's like, yeah.
But I mean, see, some things are blatant racism, but there are a lot of things that white people don't even realize is not even blatant racism, that be racist. You know what I'm saying? But if you live in like Iowa somewhere and everyone around you is participating in this form of racism that might not be fuck the niggers, but you know what I mean?
Something maybe a little more subtle.
Something a lot more subtle. That's why Get Out was so popular, especially for a lot of black people, you feel me? Mm. So it's like, you know what I mean? You can't help yourself almost. So to work towards wanting to be better, man, that's the thing. I mean, so when you get in this Hollywood game, I mean, yeah, let me ask right here. But yeah, so like I could say that being an artist helped me, like, oh, you know, like you gonna have empathy just as a human being, but being an artist and experiences I got on that road, all the different people that I met, all the different brains and different perspectives that when you're open to that you come across and such, I'm not gonna be the same guy I was in 98. In 2001, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Even in 2005 or 2010, bitch, because you can't help, you know, you can't help stretch and grow. So that's why I'm always pushing for like, nah, man, Mike, yes, go to the women's theory class. I'm not ribbing you about going to the motherfucker. I'm just surprised that you decide to go. Like, I'm actually impressed. You know what I'm saying? But it just was funny, dog, on those tips. But anyway, man, I don't know.
I guess as a side note, man, Moms was like, man, you always really got to switch it up and go somewhere where people won't expect you to be to really, like, get popping and, like, find some knowledge.
Oh, no. I mean, my grandma put me on that early about, basically about, like, let me throw you these other places you could get these experiences. Like, for summers, I would always go to two camps every year. Mm-hmm. I would go to the camp I really like, and I'll go to some white camp that was something that was of education or some shit. I call it a white camp. It should be educational, but you always have all these white people here.
All these white kids.
All these white people.
Other black niggas read. What?
But it also was a freaking testament to the fact that, especially when we were coming up, a lot of black kids didn't go to camps unless it was like that free shit.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But like to go to... I went to what they would call coding camp when I was like fucking 13 or 12, because it was like some computer programming camp or some shit. And they had other black people there, but we were minority than the mother. I wasn't like the only one. Yeah. But let's say if there's like 100 white kids, there's like maybe 12 of us, you know what I'm saying? At the very most, you dig? So it'd be shit like that, because like I always wanted to act. I have these other motherfucking interests that grandma be like, oh yeah, you got that interest? Let me throw you there. And many times it was, she tried to get me acclimated with different types and different styles of folk. That's why I never feel like, as an introvert, I don't like being around people generally a lot. Yep. But as far as can I swim, I can swim with any fucking body just based off of that concept.
Yeah,
getting you out there, getting you exposed. Because a lot of my friends only know how to be around black people. Or like, for instance, like y'all know, we black niggas from New Orleans. Y'all know what I'm saying, how we can really allow ourselves to be boxed if motherfucker don't make us aware of that shit.
Yes.
Like, nigga, you never leave uptown.
You hear me? And in New Orleans, boy, how we all about customs. And nigga, we will do the same thing every day until we die and think it's cool. Not think it's cool, but just be like, this is the way
this
it is.
This is it, yeah. I'm living by the pyramid, the totem.
But yeah, son, all that to say, man, we got them cameras from from them women that were so fucking cool.
Actually, that all it says is we went to college.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? That we're talking about how we came across the 48 the first time. And like that first year, it was way less teams. Way less. They only had enough teams to do one group. What, they got four group screenings now?
Yeah.
They had one screening.
We met at like some condom fucking bar off of Bourbon. Like,
oh, wow. Friendship. Okay. Yeah. See, okay, cool. So, like, it was real grassroots in the beginning.
Grassroots. We was the only black group. No, they had one other group that...
I'm sorry. I got to interject this. It's an international organization, but it was his first time being
picked
up.
In New Orleans.
Got it. So, like, some local New Orleans producer dude, I don't even think he stayed on past that first year. Or yeah. Maybe he transitioned on some second year to some other people to pass it off. I think he saw the idea and wanted to try to implement it, but I had saw it on their website and saw that they had our city on that bitch. Yeah. You know, sometimes you be seeing some... Well, I guess like how that Fyre Fest shit was. You know, you see a cool event going on. Yeah. You're trying to see when it's happening. And I see a lot of shit like that because a lot of things really don't come to New Orleans. Like, a nigga would skip us and go to Houston or Atlanta.
Yeah.
Like, so I like, you know, I was like, all right, man, it ain't going to be here. When I saw us, I was like, let me click on it. Right. And they had a link and it just went from there.
Yeah.
You know
what I mean? So that first year, like I said, it was very small. Funny enough, like I said, because one thing I always like to pride ourselves on, especially as the years would progress, was like we was the black team, like for the longest. Like we was the crew,
yeah, where
it was like
team.
The directors, the writers, all us, and we the black people. You know what I'm saying? It's gonna be a black ass story you're gonna see amongst all these white folk. You know what I'm saying?
But it ain't gonna be a black story.
But yeah, and that's the thing, we wasn't, because I was about to get to that, of a lot, every so often, because we've been doing it for all these years, every so often, another black team would pop up, but they would do something that was just like some hood shit. You know what I mean? Some regular, what they think, this what the niggas gonna do. And we was always priding ourselves on being more creative than just being with that. You know what I mean? We like, no, let's go story. It don't gotta be some nigga in the hood selling drugs or somebody who can't fucking be there for their kids. I mean, there's so many stories you could tell. Just because we black, I mean, we gotta tell that story every rip. But ironically, our first movie there had no black people.
No black people, man.
We had these, because what happened, we pulled drama, and Mike had this white girl partner that was an actor that wanted to do some shit, so that's how she got in there. I don't even know how the other white girl got involved. I don't know why I'm not acting in this movie. I don't remember how this came about, because I remember I co-wrote the bitch. I wound up co-directing the bitch.
Man, that's what it was, man. Like, our homie Cloud, shouts out to him. You know what I mean? He was like, oh, man, boom, we making movies now? All right, that's what's up. Man, my partner at the job, Ben, man, he fuck with that shit. That's how
he linked us with Ben. So that's how white people came about
that. You know what I mean?
Oh, so boom, big up to Ben and Nate.
They felt the love of the squad. These niggas fell in love with Bats. It's like, Bats, you're a star. I'm telling you, bitch. Like, you're just destined to pop. They was like, yeah. So
they really was trying to get me to pop way before I knew anything about the film game. Way before I had an agent, because like, especially Nathan's son, he actually got me this audition for this thing this one time. But they just was like excited about me. Them dudes was cool as fuck. And that's what led us to the second year. Because the first year we did work with them. And then the second year we let them take point. And like, I remember Mike was pissed because he ain't really do nothing. I was me and Chris were the main actors in this joint. Shouts out to Chris Robb, who ironically is the main actor in this one. And the one we did this year, but we'll come back to that. But but that year, they were trying to cheat, because since we did the one the first year or whatever, we kind of all
was like, son, we got a plan. They gave us like the wink and the smile, nigga. We partied, we hung out.
They already had a script that was like 5 pages long that they said no matter what they pulled, they planned to do that one regardless. So we just had, they just happened to pull what have you, whatever. And that was the first time that we saw the, because especially since then, from the beginning, I don't think we even had an opinion. We just was going to do it the right way, fair. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So when they came with that, even Fyre was feeling some kind of way, like, man, I don't know if I'm going
to
do that
shit. Like, we ain't going to do nothing. It feels comfortable to be like, man, I got a plan. But in a sense of, like,
them niggas, like, we got everything.
Dog, like, it felt good to go kick it and hang in the bar, but it didn't feel like we was making a movie. But the next day we shot that
No, we shot the movie because they had the script done.
Yeah.
So, you know what I'm saying? So, their big deal was they wanted to cast me as the main character and shit. And they brought the white girl from the last movie back. Oh, girl, her cool ass Ashley. Didn't she? No, she ain't. She came at the end. She had a cameo at the end.
Yeah.
But I'm like, yeah, son. And that was the whole deal. But from that point, like, we already were still starting to grow. And, you know, okay, we'll do it, but you got to use our people. You know what I'm saying? So that's the first black movie, but not even the one that we freaking point. Because it was really cool. It was this drama thing. But we did that with them. Then the third year.
A new body.
The third, and as you can see, the film fest is growing, you know what I mean, from first year to second year, but it's still not past one screening group. And I will say this, most of the movies visually suck. Very few people had access. Like, you know how now everybody shit, you go there now.
You shoot it with your damn phone.
Nigga, and not even just that, bitch look good.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
You shoot 4K.
Nigga, and some people for even some people for the 48 be pulling out getting reds. They be renting all this equipment, all this big dog shit. Dog, them first year too, you could tell somebody just grabbed their regular ass camcorder, got their friends, and said, we about to do some shit. They might have had like one or two teams that you felt like, oh, you must have a movie connection because your movie looks so much drastically different than anything else here. And luckily, since we had the cameras from the college, we were falling in the middle. Yeah, okay. Our cameras weren't that super fire movie quality, so they're like we'll be a notch under that one team that had that money. I know Mike's smiling about who one of them teams had that money, and we'll still be above at least these four or five other teams who ain't got no quality at all in their films. So that's like by year two, but then as the year started going on, by year three we ditched everybody. It was just ragtag bunch. That's why I wanted to be in ragtag, and then maybe that fourth year we became Gumball Monster. But
man, really, it's like we would have like I think the third year we did syphagonorrhagitis, and we had like a wit. It's like as you do it, you learn steps for things that you need to really just take the fuck out and just be yourself. Like me and B was talking about delegation. I guess that was last night, but it felt like it was
all right. A big deal. That's gonna come up a lot.
But in some shit, man, if you just sub in and like I will do this job, or like I'm definitely gonna find somebody that I know, like it's like me doing this job, then you figure it out like that. Cause like when dude had no reason to leave without footage for syphagonorrhagitis, and then it just got weird. So it's like, all right, cool, we about to start editing our own shit. So it's just like growing.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
I'm sorry. I don't want to cut. I did cut you up. Sorry.
You did.
That's sorry. Cool. No, it's not cool.
That's the question.
It's not fucking cool.
What's the question?
What happened? So the guy walked away with your footage when you said that. What happened
like,
there?
Like,
every
you know,
year you learn something new.
We did the 48.
First year, we learned the 48.
Yeah.
The second year, we realized, okay, we don't want to do this cheating shit. We want to do it on ourselves.
Okay.
Third year, we learned, don't trust nobody but the footage but us. Because the nigga, we brought in a nigga to edit. Who partner this was?
One of the cloud partners.
He was our editor, and he edited on his shit, and then he disappeared.
Yeah, man, dude vamped out. I think later he, like, wind up. No, that was another dude, but never mind. Yeah, man, dude just disappeared with our footage, so, like, we couldn't adjust the movie.
We
was just stuck with what we had.
We
like,
never got
was,
it. Yeah, I guess I'm about to
yeah, yeah, like, that was the movie, and, like, even in talking about it, it was like, you know, it's the, wait, was that the one that was 15?
Yeah, fifth year, we didn't give a fuck.
Oh, yeah,
fuck
right,
that
cool.
Yet.
So, boom, we came in with the German suplex ass.
We gave a 15 minute
like,
movie.
Boom, bitch, you gonna eat this bitch. They loved it. They love it.
We might be, but we still like, might be the reason why they stopped accepting, but stopped showing
15 minute films.
Yeah, because we fucked over them like twice like that. But like, because the first time we did it, it was Civil Guy Real Giants. It's their third year in the game. They, you know, and once again, we probably still have one screening group.
Yeah.
Maybe it went to two, but I'm still thinking it's on one by the time we do Sipa. Because the way they acted about Sipa, they were so legendary about it. Because like he said, them people love that fucking movie.
Niggas still talk about that shit. We signed
yeah,
up.
Yeah, they
oh, man,
know us
job.
Still from that. That's like the third or fourth year we did it. And it's just whatever. It's a goofy-ass film, you feel me? But it just stuck out to them because that's when we started, I guess, our brand started coming as these quirky black people. You feel me? Because when you, it's that shit we just were talking about. If you're used to Wisconsin, and everybody's from Wisconsin, and everybody making movies just how they make them in Wisconsin. When these niggas from fucking New York coming to Wisconsin and show you how they make fucking movies, you're like, that's the shiny thing. What is up with that? Right. They're not following these rules. Because that's another thing. We ain't follow. You could see the difference that year. You know what I'm saying? And we learned. I mean, but you know, I often say we always make this one version for them that's like 7 minutes. Then we go back and make our own version with all the things that we like want to add and like. That's what made us want to do that, because as much as them people like syphagonorrhagitis, it was frustrating not knowing what could have been. We didn't get to re-edit it. We didn't get to see any other scenes to see if we could have made it funnier, better, more longer lasting. You know, I mean, there's so many things that was taken from us when that nigga just disappeared with the footage that made things even more in-house, like you were fucking saying.
Yeah, so it's like every time you have a great, great fucking failure, that'd be your learning. That's like you need to fail to catch a good learning block. Like, on light and shit, I've learned so much. Like, I've learned enough. But no, I'm lying. I've learned so much than I did from, like, day one. But still, at the same time, I could see me back here, like, being like, man, what is this? Like, you know, I'm learning what's the words, what's the phrases, what's the questions I really need to be asking. When I was just before, like, kind of just shooting in the dark. Like, this shit, dude came through with the lighting. Like, I need it like this, and it was like that. So, and like, and I knew, and I knew how it needed to be. He was telling me some other shit. I'm like, nigga, I don't give a fuck about none of that shit. My science tell me 1 + 2 gonna give me 3, bitch. Do what I do, give me my 3. You know what I mean? So, like, once you get comfortable in that level, like, but it requires fuck ups. I hate to say it. Like, you could be so confident in your skill, but you need a fuck up to be like, all right, I'm gonna be better.
And one of the things that this thing has taught me that I'm mad that it's really fully resonating like now. And maybe a little bit last year, like in the past couple of years, is dog, you gotta be doing shit like this all year.
Yes. Yeah. Okay. That was a fucking like hit in the face.
What's jam, dog?
This year.
We've been talking a lot. What's up? Yeah. What you saying? How'd that hit you? That boy, I should see Marty face light up like, oh my god, there's so much.
I gotta call in the chick though, because me and you work differently, but because of the way I work, I always stay in work mode. I haven't been working for the last 5 months, but I'm always working on projects.
No,
the
not
kids.
The fuck. I do the same thing. I teach the kids not the
fucking
same.
No, I'm not teaching. I'm saying actually.
No,
like,
no, I'm not. No, not. I understand what you're saying.
Yeah.
That's your job. What you get paid to do is make these movies with these kids. I was making movies with the kids all the years that we did the 48. That is not what I mean.
Mm-hmm.
I mean specifically with your squad that you're doing these 48s with these grown adults and this actual shit on the line and this footage that you put your passion into that you hope can get you paces, et cetera, et cetera. Mm-hmm. Not these kids who you got to pull up and all this other shit. That's a different thing with children that you're getting paid to teach versus your passion and your shit on your own time. You should be creating and doing shit with the team to build this fucking synergy, nigga.
Mm-hmm.
You ain't... Nigga, that's this way. I'm not trying to say you ain't been working. No, don't take it personally. I'm saying specifically groups. Like you with Rogue Martians, you feel me? Or like how we do Gumball Monster, what have you, son. There's so much to give to if we were doing this shit with our team throughout the year, by the time you get to the 48, it's just another thing.
Yeah.
On top of it removes favoritism and ego feelings and people feeling a certain way because motherfuckers got more touches at the ball. I was already telling you that, dog. You know what I mean? Because this year...
We're 82 games, baby, not one.
Dog, because this year we had a... And that's another thing. I felt bad. I'm not acting. I said, I'm just going to fall. I'm helping. I'm writing and directing this year. That's it, you feel me? Yeah. I'm not helping choose no story. I'm going to help throw out story ideas. But when it comes down to vote... Funny enough, I have not voted on a story in the past 5 years. I've created a lot of stories, throwing a bunch of the stories out there. A lot of them bitches be my ideas, dog. But when it comes down to the vote, I let the team vote because I don't want nobody to look at Bats and be like, well, Bats keep choosing these stories. Well, I don't get a chance to act. Fuck. No, bitches. Y'all chose this story or y'all chose that story because, again, like Mike say, over time and years and dealing with people and growing, you can see what fuckeries can happen. You see bad seeds getting planted, human nature, all kind of crazy shit. But in the gist of it, one thing that I've learned is if... You do it more. Like, for instance, we had three. This was a three-character joint. Two dudes and a woman. You feel me? Okay. Meaning if you got 5 women that's wanting to act and 5 dudes that's wanting to act and you got a motherfucking film that got 2 dudes and a goddamn woman and it's time to fucking cast the shit, now what do you do when the only time you ever make movies is once a year? Motherfuckers look at that goal different.
You put everybody who showed up in the movie.
Right? You know what I'm saying? And if you hear right now... Even if I know you said, call me, I want to be in a movie, or with da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Man, we on this casual. If you wasn't in my face when we was doing this, look, this Nick, we got a movie.
Oh, y'all had that situation too?
And to a degree, in a way, but I'm saying that's the game when you're doing it once a year, and you under a time crunch of 48 hours. It's a different situation than, oh, we have time to plan. I have time to cast and know that I'm other things I'm gonna do. I got 3 weeks, a month, whatever, to make this. Oh, Sherelle, I couldn't put you in a movie this time. Guess what? I got this next movie for you. Because guess what? We make movies every year. Oh, Lawrence, you didn't get a chance to be in a movie this year. Guess what? I mean, this month? Guess what? We make another movie next month, nigga. It's a different feeling. Yeah. So there's so much that go into that, dog.
I don't even want to do the Mike5 thing and be like, that nigga Bats was talking. I totally wasn't listening, but I was. Because that pisses him off.
Oh my god.
But I'm saying, like, they should have more opportunities within the city, though, like the 48 every year as well, so people can have, like, some kind of, like...
I'm not putting that on the city.
No, I'm not putting it on the city.
What you're saying is right, but what I'm saying is so separate from that,
True.
When I'm saying this on your own gumption, nigga.
Yeah.
You heard me? Once again, if we were in Wisconsin and there was no 48 or nothing, if you want to make a fucking movie, get a camera, get your people, and make movies throughout the year so you can have that fucking synergy, that fucking machine work, and less lack of ego because everybody understand and trust each other and y'all riding, y'all working. Yeah. Ain't got nothing to do with the fucking city throwing out.
I want it to be like the whole, like, yeah, I don't know. I keep thinking in sports terms, but like, like this is the fucking summertime like league or whatever championship shit, like, you know what I'm saying? But you working at this shit like seasons and shit the whole year, you know what I'm saying? There's a whole bunch of shit that goes down before that, like you just prepping to get to this moment and giving this moment the best that you have.
Yeah,
because you've been working toward that the whole time. You know what I mean? Like,
you don't go from scrimmage games to the Super Bowl, bro.
Yeah.
You know what I mean,
man?
And everybody will play in the Super Bowl, but bitch.
But it's like, you know what? It's like,
but this, but the thing is, the 48 shouldn't be the Super Bowl. It should just be any fucking other game. But yeah, it's gonna be the Super Bowl.
Right. Exactly. Yeah. So. Yeah.
But tell me about you, some of your shit, son. Like, damn, dog.
Yeah, man. I think the biggest thing was going into this thing without our editor, man, because he got taken away. And I think I kind of said this last time.
He's in the military.
Nah,
he
got
killed.
I didn't just say you got to get another nigga, right?
He called me, dog, I'm in jail. I got you, son. Click, you know what I mean? My son said in public, if you get arrested, B, and you get go to jail, I'm going to just tell everybody. He was taken away.
You heard me?
He was taken away.
You hear me?
He was taken away, bro.
But I'm sorry.
Yeah. No.
Well, I'm like, boy, that shit, boy, where you at? All right.
Well,
look, this shit up.
My son made him seem like he got kidnapped.
I sure the fuck did, right?
Like Liam Neeson found him a blockbuster.
Dire situation. Yeah, I know.
I was torn between trying to save my friend, make the 48. Bitch, what? Yeah, save your partner.
Man, but I got this movie, though. But yeah, he had to ship off earlier than planned, and that was rough, man. And not for even for all the reasons that I thought it would be, man. Because there was a lot of like don't get me wrong, I miss Chris just in general. And I want to say that just in case this hits his ears or whatever. I don't know, but Him at the computer, dude. Oh God, I needed that. I needed that back, because me at the computer was just ugh. I don't know, man. I don't know, but yeah, missed him. Missed him. That was rough. Sorry, I'm back. We're real dark.
Right.
That was real dark.
That nigga just went back to the experiences. That's I just saw like a million dark, things man. Run through your fucking eyes.
Oh, did you?
Yo,
oh, shit. Funny. Yeah, I was like, oh, yeah. Oh, no, I did. A lot of shit did just go through my head. Just, no, but yeah, thank you for telling the listening audience.
It was a lot of crickets. I was like, oh, my God. Yeah.
Goosebumps.
He gave it nothing.
Oh, yeah. No, man. Oh, okay. So. But nah, so basically, just the editing process was a little rough for me. But
do you normally edit?
Hmm?
Do you normally edit?
Not like a narrative, never really. Just on, like highlight reels.
On this podcast, we've made it very clear.
Oh, that and I don't.
Marty hates editing. It's not even that he even don't even know how.
I'm not a fan of it.
And that's because there's a few things in the, we talked about on the other podcast leading up to the 48 about, you know, the 48 and and if you listen to last year, you already know the deal. But besides Marty hating editing, and it was also Marty didn't want to get a certain goddamn genre.
Yeah, we talked about that to the ground, and then I pulled it, which they gave us a back door. We got, you know, Western or animal.
But bitch, you got Western, dog.
But I
was joked out. So it comes time to the drawer, right? I ain't even at the building yet. Mike and them already there. Marty and them already there. I'm trying to get there. Mike always draw anyway, dog. And once again, you got to get there. And they don't release you to like 7:30 to go do your thing.
They ran over.
Well, I mean, they also gave us an extra 30 minutes that I wish you would have used now.
Oh,
like,
did they?
No, before, dog, like that shit would be, you would be like disqualified. I wasn't fucking with
that
it.
That has nothing to do with what I just said. That has nothing to do with it. I'm saying they had that extra 30 minutes.
How did
y'all
find out that they had an extra 30 minutes?
When you get there, son, we got there to turn it in and they had the fucking timer. And we got there at like 6:58 and they said 30 minutes. Like, because they knew, because think about it, they ran over and given us our elements this year to at least 7:30. So they gave that extra 30 minutes. Now, they didn't give it to 8. No, I'm saying that usually, like what Five just said, 7 on that dot, bitch, y'all, fuck you. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
And this year, like when we got there at like 6:55, something so close to 7, son, and them niggas still had the timer like going. And I'm wishing that, if I'd have known that the timer going, then a good 7 minutes I wish we'd have gave to watch like, our film one last time.
I saw that 30 and shit, you heard me? But I just was like, man, I'm not really. Like, I'm here. I have y'all shit for once. We ain't rendering nothing.
We've been burned too many times. We've been burned too many times.
Right. Oh, excuse me.
My son got trauma.
Let me step to the side. Oh, you stepped on the other. You just
my
lost.
My son got trauma. So, we're at the drawing. Before I even get to the drawing, son, I get text from Lawrence in the group chat. And Lawrence said, we got Rogue movie. And me and him and a few other people like, what the fuck is a rogue movie? R-O-G-U-H. I mean, R-O-G-U-E. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, King Raheem is like, is that like a movie about like if a spy went rogue? And I was like, I guess. I don't remember rogue movie. Like, I remember even spy and espionage being the thing.
Yeah.
What the fuck is a rogue movie? Then he texts back. Then you text me that, you motherfucker, are you here? Now it's like, now I'm almost there, bro. He's like, man, he's like, we pulled. Guess what I got, basically. And as soon as he said it,
fucking pulled first too. I'm like,
yeah, dog. I don't know what the fuck is wrong with you. You hear me?
I'm like,
I was trying to get behind people. I thought you was with the same way. Trying to go put your hand up there first. You at least want to hear some of this shit.
But I was like,
could we have?
Can I do this though? But I was like, can I let somebody skip me and go? I'm like, nobody gonna want that.
Because you was first.
See, that's what I'm saying, bro.
My dog,
but they had people in front of me, and then they started. They just told everybody. I get like a wave of motherfuckers just got up there, no matter what group. And then they started talking that, well, we getting group A to pull first. All right, so if you're not in group A, get out the line. And then by the time everybody who wasn't in group A got out the line, I was the only motherfucking group A still there. And so, like, now I'm the first one, and I'm like, oh fuck. I was praying to that last person, and that lady, she wasn't listening, but like she left at the last second too, like, oh no, it's not me.
My son said I pulled Western, because that's the thing. So I don't know if this was even caught on or off mic, dog, because me and Marty been talking about how much he ain't want to pull Western for a while. I remember we walked into this was off mic, because we walked into the goddamn corner store before the last episode, and I was like, Marty, we gotta stop talking about this, because we're gonna jinx you.
And I was like, he's right.
Yeah.
I probably already did it now that he said it.
And I was like, dog, you probably gonna get it now.
Yeah.
And then when he texted me, he really pulled Western, dog.
In the back of my mind, and you saw me, bro, I was like fucking with it a little bit. It was like, nigga, that was fate right there. Like, no matter what. Like, when I reached my hand in that bitch, all them motherfuckers said Western. Like, it was that kind of shit. You know what I'm saying? There was no way I was gonna not pull Western. I am like, fuck, man. All right.
So,
but I knew I had a back door because it was always two genres.
They gave you animal. They gave you Western and animal. Right. And we really wound up getting road movie, like a road trip, road movie, and we got fantasy. And so again, you could choose road movie or fantasy, or you could do a road movie fantasy. You could choose animal movie, Western or animal movie, or do both. And I could have sworn you were going to go Western. So you motherfuckers wound up doing an animal film.
Oh, yeah, man, we did. It was actually, it was pretty fun.
It was Psychic Pets.
What's going on?
It was,
how'd you get about it? I mean, so when you pull a goddamn thing and y'all meet up at home base, what happened?
So we're going to start here. Okay.
Yeah, cool. We're going to give it to him.
All right. So, and that's, okay, great. So basically what I do is, I text Jenny. Jenny's my partner, my work wife. Hey,
Jenny.
Shout
out to Jenny.
Shout out to Jenny. Everybody needs a Jenny L. Martin. I text her what the genres are, and not everybody's freaking out like I am, but I'm like, you know, I preordained this whole thing, so I just can't let it go. And then Jenny hits me back, like, even before they give us like the character and the prop and all that stuff. Like, she texts me back and she has an idea about about turning her cat into like a human or whatever. And that'll be the whatchamacallit. You were kind of talking about that when we were there.
Yeah.
You were telling me something like that too. Yeah.
Like, yo, let me give you something just to run with.
Right.
I feel like ain't no hurting team spirit. Plus, I don't have animal film, my nigga.
Yeah.
Word. Even before this shit, I had talked about with you. We be running shit on like nigga. This the shit we don't really have. So you picked up one of the ones that we was like, man, we in a dangerous zone with animal films. Like, we probably would have really went Western because we could play style.
Yeah, because that's the thing, too, Five. On air, I said, Marty, this is how much we talked about this.
Yeah.
I even broke down on air, like, if you get Western, this is how we play it. This is such and such. So, like, yeah, we could have done Western. I don't know what the hell we'd have done for animal.
That was another one of those things, man, where you're talking about, like, I guess that's what I was having trouble articulating was I came into this 48 feeling the most like kind of left out isn't the word, but like sort of
dejected.
So there were meetings and stuff like that they had that I was, you know, I tried to make it to, but just trying to balance in the party over here thing and making those meetings and stuff. No, not lonely.
He out the bubble.
Not lonely. It's like out the bubble. That's the word. Yeah, I felt like I was out the bubble a little bit coming in.
Yeah.
Exactly. Right. So like it just, I don't know. There's something probably I had just created in my head, but. Anyway, there were meetings and stuff that I just couldn't make it to creatively. So they had kind of had some ideas and stuff, and they had kind of touched bases and everything. So I was just trying to come in and just, you know, catch up, basically.
And you director this year? What's that? You were in director hat?
That can
make you feel a little lonely. If you're out the boat, you got to steer the ship.
Well, no, I just felt bad because I missed the meetings also, too. Like we said about making plans for the year. So like, I just, honestly, I felt like absent. You know what I'm saying? Like I felt like I made promises about, yo, I'm gonna get these scripts done and then we're gonna go out and we're gonna shoot, and everybody was like, yeah, cool, all right, we're gonna wait on your call. Scripts never came, call never came.
Yeah.
So you know what I'm saying? Now we have these meetings and stuff, and it's like, damn, you couldn't fucking make the meet, nigga.
Shit, fuck.
Yeah. I'm just like, if I was on the other side looking at that, I'm like, this nigga don't give a fuck.
You know
what I'm saying? And I'm just like, and why the fuck are we listening to him? Then we gonna follow this nigga again into this shit?
Yeah.
And then which is gonna get to the story at the end. But you know what I'm saying? I was just like, fuck, man, you gotta make up for all that shit.
Right.
This time around or whatever. And it's like, so basically, back to this year. So Jenny hits me back with the idea.
Yeah.
And then we're kind of hitting it. We're talking about ideas and whatnot. And I'm like, okay, cool. So she's wondering when we get there, like, will that fall under the guides of it? I'm like, well, Mike just told me somebody did this. And I'm like, they fell under the guidelines for them. I'm pretty sure we'll be all right here. So, you know, she started writing the script.
Metaphor shit?
Yeah. The dog.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah. He did get the cat.
Yeah, they did with the cat, right. So, basically, Jenny wrote the script. We went into the script. Like, so the day before, I hit Jenny up, and I'm like, you know what Bat said about the script? And, like, you know, spending too much time on a script and da-da-da-da-da. Like, you know, maybe we can improv some of this stuff. I know a couple of actresses, I know they'll be able to run it, whatever. And, you know, for the ones who we may feel like, you know, or if anybody feels like they can't, like, let's just have a little something on the page for them, and then we'll kind of go from there.
I have an ironic star to put there. We're going to come back to it.
Okay. So we kind of went into it, like, loosely thinking, like, okay, cool, we'll just have them improv here. And it's just like, okay, cool. So I'm pitching scenes. But technically, I guess, now that I'm thinking about it, some of those scenes weren't really in the script. So it became at one point it became a question of, okay, so what's in the script? And then I'm like, oh yeah, this scene ain't in the script. Touche. So I should, like, there should have been like some sort of outline or something for everything, which we didn't have. And
in my improv spiel to you, for Marty, I said you gotta have a script.
Oh, did you say script?
It's a bonus.
What did you do?
For people to act on.
What do you mean? We have a script. We just don't write the specific dialogue.
Clearly, I built a stick of dynamite and lit the end of it.
You gotta have the guide. It has to be a map, yo. If you don't have a map, you can't.
We did have a script.
Okay.
Like, we did have a script, but just there was some things that weren't as I guess, I don't know, no. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, there was a couple things that weren't in the script.
You got to put it in
that
the
they
script.
Weren't, yeah, no.
That's the thing. My thing is, don't get bogged down by dialogue.
Right.
Have the story broken down to the point where everybody's very clear on what happens in every scene, but you got to have every scene written down in the fucking script.
There was some times where I was just like, okay, y'all just going to walk down this hallway, y'all going to badmouth the boyfriend.
I mean, that's not a... I mean, That
oh,
should be
that counts.
I mean, that's an example of something that should be easy for two actors to do. Okay. If you know what you need from them, yeah. But it's another right. kick if you know. I mean, I don't know. Even time skates, if you just throw in random things that don't that the story. That's not fitting the story. Like, what do you mean you left something out of the screen? Like, I'm going to keep my back.
Okay. Yeah, though, you opening up class.
Like, but he made me feel bad. I'm like, man, I hope I ain't tell this man wrong. It fucked his world up. But then
I clearly I misinterpreted it like the wrong way. Because I was, that was just, like, to be honest with you, man, most of that shit is a blur. And because I didn't write the script this year, like, I don't have a lot of it committed to memory. So it's like, I'd have to go back and look at it, dude, because yeah. It's not all there. And it's like, man, after going to sleep, dude, and waking up, I felt like I just woke up from a long-ass dream. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like, the last 2 days, oh, man, the whole thing is like just a blurry haze over it. But yeah, I feel like there were a couple of scenes that weren't in the script that we still shot. And for the most part, though, there's only one scene in particular that I'm thinking about. And that was going to be the opening, but we wind up cutting it for time. Like, we actually, I thought we were going to actually be under, like at 5 minutes or something like that, you know, just enough to be in. But it turned out being, like, 8 or 9 minutes by the time I got to the end of it. Mm. And, yeah, but basically, yeah, so Jenny writes the script. We go to home base is her crib this year because it's normally Chris's crib, but, you know, of course, he's gone this year. So we...
I miss you, Chris.
Yeah, Miss Chris. So we went over to Jenny's crib, and we shot a lot of it over there by her house.
Smart.
Yeah, yeah. What else happened after that? So Jenny finishes maybe around.
I'm gonna say this: there's nothing wrong with adding scenes that weren't in the script if you think of something new, but you have to be able to justify why you're shooting the motherfuckers.
Yeah.
Because you know what I mean? Because you already know this too as a shooter, director, etc. You got to be editing on the fly while you also making a movie. Mm. So it's like, I mean, like, so why, you know, why you doing it, you got to think, okay, this time I'm going to do this. Even so sometimes you might not get the shot you really wanted originally, but then you got to be like, okay, well, can I get this instead? Okay, this is satisfied at this time I edit it. And it's almost, sometimes I'm already jumping to, okay, this time I have to edit it then. Mm. So if those scenes that you're adding out the blue, you already know how you're going to edit that bitch.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Then
there's merit there. Like, it's not like you just saying out the blue, you know what? I think we should just get on this roof. You know what I mean? For no motherfucking reason. You hear me? That's bad. But if you got a reason and a justification, there's nothing wrong with it. It's hard even when you're on a time crunch. But yeah. I say, generally speaking, it's not a bad rule to be like, well, if you really want something, get that bitch. Because we got a piece of our story where, like, I was telling Mike after the fact, because I didn't know something like that happened with him. And I was like, shit, nigga. Wish you would've got that bitch, you know what I mean?
Yeah, we had like a coverage discrepancy, but at the same time, like...
I'm gonna come back to it. What you saying? We just... Like, we gonna tell you about our first day. We gonna go day for day.
Okay.
You tell us about your Friday. We gonna tell about our Friday enough. Right after.
So our Friday... Yeah, Friday was basically writing the script. So Jenny wrote the script. I'm not sure exactly when she finished, man. Like I said, it was a little bit of a blur, but I wanna say around like 12, we got everybody there. Like, all the actresses showed up. It was mostly female cast, but one cat, like, we really didn't have any male actors, so we kind of, because we wanted to turn, like, originally the idea was...
What a problem. we're like yeah. nothing but niggas.
Are you serious?
I mean, I had some girls on call, but
shit, yeah.
The crew was kind of all just birds.
A lot of dudes. Yeah. I mean, we had Roxy, we had Rel double dipping with us and y'all.
Yeah,
we had Jay, we had Trina double dipping with us and y'all, but Trina was like, let me know when you need me, if you don't need me, et cetera, et cetera.
Right.
Because she hit me up that Saturday morning, she hit me up asking, you need me? Two niggas and a chick, bro. You might as well go do your thing. Like, we can't really do nothing.
Oh, wow, yeah. So we kind of had the same situation, but when we, like, oh, shit.
Y'all didn't use Trina?
We didn't use Trina.
Yo!
We didn't, so what happened was we ran out of, like, when. So we had to shoot a couple people out. So, but in order to shoot the scenes, we had to, do them right there. Mm. Like, so we wound up, like, that first day, really, Friday, felt... Like, we went all the way into Saturday morning.
Now, I heard that from Rel. Rel came back by us, like, Saturday.
See, that's, like, okay, so you know what? Something extremely funny. I didn't even know that she was with y'all.
Yeah.
I didn't even realize that. But, okay, fair enough.
But, no, but she just came to kick it. She was, like, she helped with story.
Right.
And she was there if we needed her acting. But Rel was just on those, like, you know what I mean? if you need me, let me know.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, she's da 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 da. A similar thing that happened to y'all this year because last year we didn't know one of your members was with you guys.
Oh, for real?
And we got fucked.
Oh, for real?
We had that conversation last year. If you want to know about it, check out 48 Hour, reviewing that 48 from last year. But like, yeah, a very key motherfucker that we thought was just for us wound up being for y'all too. And then we got ditched. But continue. Friday.
Okay, I think, it's coming back to me now. I think I got it. But yeah, Friday, yeah. So Friday, we wind up casting most of it.
Oh, yeah, the thing I was saying was, Rel told me that y'all was like already, like halfway done, already shooting all on Friday. And I'm like, damn, nigga, y'all shooting like night. I'm curious, like, because we usually don't start shooting till Saturday, dog. Damn, y'all got steam.
Well, bro, so here's the thing, man. Like, guy who was extremely nervous about editing was like let's start shooting as soon as possible. Like, let's get this thing finished.
What is y'all's story?
We think we had the whole story. I think me and Jenny kind of kicked it about a little bit more by the time I made it to her crib, like, after we left. And then, she started writing it, and I think she was maybe done in, like, 2 hours at the most. Mm-hmm. So then...
So y'all had a decision made. So you get home at, like, let's say y'all reconvene at, what, like, 8, 7:30, 8 o'clock?
Yeah, like 8:30 or so, yeah.
And you have a movie by, what, like 11? You have a script by,
yeah, by, like, 11, 11:30, yeah.
So y'all had no other... Y'all already had no other options? Because on our Friday, we delegated through ideas like a motherfucker. So y'all just was like, this the one, boom?
Yeah, we just kind of ran with it.
Damn, all right, cool.
Yeah. That was up.
Yeah, man. Go ahead.
Yeah, y'all had steam like that boy talking about.
Yeah, it was real. Yeah, steam is ahead this year. and no, it was not. Like, yeah.
Marty,
they can see my face.
Yes, yeah, with the podcast.
And like, my face is probably like, yeah, I don't. There's so probably many, should hit the brakes a little bit.
There's so many.
But, you know, it's cool.
If you're giving us so many hooks right now,
yeah, I'm feeling like, so,
oh my
sorry.
God, I,
like we,
they
like
said
we
should, a bad hit coming.
Like, we should have.
Yeah,
oh,
well, yeah, you excited, bitch?
Well, gee, I see the iceberg. I see the iceberg that I didn't realize I would see, but it's over there, dog. Keep going.
I'm just...
It was Saturday, and I realized, what the fuck?
What the fuck am I doing? I'm not going to lie, though, straight up. Like, to tell my... I wasn't mentally prepared for this, because I really don't think I was. But I was like, man, I can't wait till we done it. I can go home and smoke and watch Hulu. Oh, I was like, nigga, that's not happening. Like, I didn't smoke the whole weekend. I was like, oh my God.
You didn't smoke the whole weekend?
Nah. I thought I had something on reserve in my pocket, and then when I opened the shit up.
Time out, pause, dog. I ain't even trying to recap, dog. I told you last year, dog, you need to create your element for you to be creative, dog. No matter what. Because you trying to do something. But I went in this... out the sky to get some weed, boy. Like,
no,
boy.
word. Yeah. I went in my space.
I just got to say, man. If y'all get tired of niggas not getting no weed on the set, y'all tired of motherfuckers not keeping you high on the set.
Oh no, you didn't, nigga.
Y'all need to come on, check over with Gumbo Monster Film, you hear me? Cause we keep our actors and our crew high, you dig? And we'll talk all over the record.
Oh, okay.
You dancing all in the video.
Okay, alright. I gotta give you that one, sir. Okay.
Come on, Marty, come join us.
The weed's
good over here.
You know what? I don't know if it would have been a problem. I know at one point Jenny had said it was okay, but I remember seeing signs like all around, like her like any place that you would potentially go smoke. Saying that if anybody's caught, like, you know, smoking, and there was like a weed, you know, picture of a weed plant with
stop sign things through it.
So it was like, okay,
this is
cool.
Like an apartment she lives in, like, this?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm about to say, where do you live, Jimmy?
That is the rules.
And I was like, wow.
Like, y'all know the blue plate?
I got you. See, for a second, I thought you said, we was in our house, and you just looked around, and it just was, I go to the bathroom, this ain't no fucking weed here, I go to the room, there's a sign that say no weed. I was like...
Like, her mother was real particular about this. You know? But, I wasn't in my element, man, actually, now that you mentioned it, and that to that extent, but It didn't. I don't know. I've kind of done this before.
Yeah.
Where it's like, you know, you just kind of stop for a couple of days or whatever, or, you know, longer periods of time, which, yeah, whatever. Anyway, but yeah, it was cool. Which, anyway, never mind. Why, man? Why? Okay, so first night we just, we basically, yeah, we shot through it. We got a lot of stuff done that first day. And then I think we might have broken up around like when the sun came up. I do remember like grabbing a cigarette with David, our sound guy, like, and the sun being up before we broke for that first day. So basically we shot like, let me see, how many scenes did we shoot? We shot 1, 2, 3, 4... like 4 scenes that first night, like from 12 to fucking 6. And then we took another break and reconvened like Saturday around 2:00.
2 p.m.
Yeah.
Interesting.
So what was y'all first day like? That's
Friday we get this started for us for like 7. Oh no,
it's 7:30, 8:00. About 7:30.
We made it back to the spot.
About 7:30, 8:00. We all were getting together, you feel me?
Where's your home base at?
5 miles.
Yeah.
It dig, you know,
secret
like
secret location.
Well, we always do is, you know, we get up, we let everybody know if you're interested in putting in our story, make it to Mike's house by 7:30. Oh, what have you? I was hungry as shit. I need to eat. Niggas, nigga had to eat. Luckily, Mike, shouts out to Kelly, man.
No, pause on this. Yes, keep going.
Shouts out to Mike's girlfriend, Kelly.
Nobody reads the fucking email, period.
That's fine.
What?
They had tacos at that motherfucker.
Oh,
that
dope.
Kelly had made.
Yeah.
Mwah. I went straight to get me some tacos and shit.
That's Saturday.
So it was Friday. I ate something Pasta. Friday. Pasta, same difference, because the same thing happened to me. Right. So anyway, because the guy, when the tacos popped up, I was like, ooh, tacos. But there was pasta, first night, pasta.
Yeah.
Kill up the pasta, roll up the weed, everybody rolling the weed, we all up in there, you know, we here with squad, you feel me?
Yeah.
And yeah, man, we had gone, dude, we had come up with a good 6 road stories and 4 or 5 fantasy stories to choose from.
Mm-hmm. Oh, nigga, we kicked like about 22 ideas, like,
nigga. Shouts out to Joseph Pines, Alpha Joe, nigga. This nigga was a freaking
machine.
Yeah, he just kept even good, bad, indifferent, whatever. He was just what about this? Well, what about this? Like, he had ideas to just throw at the freaking wall. Okay. You know what I'm saying? So, but like, yeah, it came down to, you know, we going through them, and then at a point it came down to 2, and whatever. Okay. And see, I'm helping with the story. I'm throwing out ideas. I'm going doing everything I need to do. But again, I like to keep it varied because I'm still aware in my mind something that I don't think everyone else is.
What's that?
Depend upon the story. Depend upon who get to touch that ball.
Okay. Well, that's something that came up afterward.
No. I'm always, even if I'm not verbalizing that.
Cause you got you really thinking about who's gonna act in the movie?
My G.
Talking all this story shit.
It's always about the story.
Yeah.
But at the same time, once we have multiple options and it's time we see what we gonna vote on, I'm trying to be aware of which story got characters. Mm. We story got women. Because remember, even for ours, we got 2 women and a dude. We got 2 dudes and a chick. But I even posed, should we do 2 women and a dude? But then we realized in this situation, it's more impactful if it's 2 dudes. But still, at the same freaking time. You know what I mean? Like, bro. I'm trying. Because I don't remember what year it was for us. But they had this thing about it at times where, like, we had new people on board. And they was feeling like they weren't going to be able to touch the ball because it was only going to go to the same people. Mm-hmm. Not taking in. Those people are there because so many other people abandoned us.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? Why is Bats in 5 films? Because 5 actors fucking abandoned us, and now Bats got to do this one. Oh, I got to be here. Oh, Raheem's here now. I can rely on you, son. If I'm used to dealing with these people I can rely on, and I'm at this point knowing their skill set, yeah, they going to get touches at the ball. But also, you better take in too, bitch. If you ain't here, what I'm supposed to fucking do? You dig? So it got to the point where it's like you hear these grumblings. That's why I always talk about team morale. You got to be communicative of people feeling like left out and shit when I ain't trying to leave nobody out. But there's 1, you hear me? You got to be here. And 2, watch what stories are being picked. If you actively are voting to pick on a story that has 3 roles, and you know, there's like 4 women, and you picking a movie which the story has 1 female role. Why are you fucking voting for that? You know what I'm saying? If the story is about a goddamn 6-foot tall nigga with muscles, and we need a 6-foot tall nigga with muscles opposite a very short midget, you hear me? And you're motherfucking Mike, and Mike saying, "Well, I can't get him." Are you fucking 6 feet? So, are you fucking 3 feet tall? You chose to vote on this story, yo. Like, take that in. So I started trying to think for others at that point, like, yo, like, maybe we shouldn't go this one, because then you can't act. Or maybe we should go this one, but then people start being like, I don't care if I do this, we just, okay, fine.
But when we got to our last two choices, I think, well, I don't know what you're about,
what you about to say, my nigga?
Oh, no, I was going to say that, I was going to ask, so does that mean that, like, everybody kind of comes in with that same mindset, like, it's all about the best story?
And that's then, what, like, I when always that, when that gets chosen.
That's what he kind of drives, or like at least how we try to drive the session, because the best story will pull everything forward.
Yes.
Like team morale, that clutch last minute energy, like the I don't want to say.
And then some of it goes into the team, people on your team, because you know some of the people, whatever, but I'm an empath, so I'm always trying to be aware. So no, personally, I always drive story home. You know what I mean? It should be about the best story. But you can't help the human condition, which goes back to what we said earlier. Yeah. People can't, if you ain't got no other outlet to do this thing, and the main outlet that you do have is this, and you only do it once a year, then these things become more important and bigger. And like, yes, you do want to have the best story, but a lot of people want to be part of the best story. They want to be in the best story. They want to tell it. And but yeah, you're talking about actors that need reels, people that need experience. You know what I mean? Everybody got their own shit coming into why they're doing things. And again, if you only do one movie a year and you got a nigga over here that's hoping to build his reel, and you the only friend of his that got a camera, only one that can edit, and he ain't getting no touches because his agent, or might not even have an agent, with that dude, shit like this gets important. I try to be aware of that. Like I was telling Mike the other day, dog, we have, out of all the years we've been doing this, Lawrence has not been the main character in any of the films. Joseph has not been a lead character in any of the films. And these are two mainstays. If you watch any of our movies, they're in all of them, ready to support, but sometimes the cookie don't crumble in their direction to be the fucking lead because it don't match, or other people might. I've even got to a point where I'm like, I'm not even casting. Y'all want, nigga!
And I'm not putting myself,
I do, because for the longest, I became like the face, and I'm like the actor that's doing all this shit, and I'm this and that, and I'm writing this, all this. So, you know what I mean? I don't want people thinking I'm just trying to just only take everything. So, I'm going to lay back and be like, yo, go get it. Oh, what's for you? But then the same motherfuckers be like, but Bats, you got to do this role. So, some of y'all were just grumbling about Bats being in the motherfucking movie. But then you same motherfuckers put Bats in the motherfucking movie, and what
damned
now?
Damned if you do, damned if you don't. Sort of situation, yeah. No,
you hear me?
I feel you.
But getting into it, like I said, we voted on our movie.
That's what I wanted to say. That's the segue before the question came up. It was coming down to like
seeing
what the two movies really needed to make them two pop.
And shout out to El Pajo again, because he pushed that, and he's like, okay, y'all, what we gonna, like, he. Joe was on it when it came to trying to get to time I'm going pushing. What you saying, Bob?
But yeah, in terms of like selecting the story, like I had a bullshit name for the movie that we made, but like Suicide Ride, just to like keep it secretive, I guess, right now.
That is not secretive.
Oh, we gotta name it. What you saying?
No, I'm saying
movie one, movie two.
Yeah, that was all right, cool.
God damn it. Movie one, you heard me, was like, all right, this bitch really requires some Shakespearean poetry, because we're gonna be trapped in a car with these two people having a conversation most of the times. And like, you know, sometimes you could, like, witty banter just kind of happens, but when you gotta force it or try to write it, that shit can take up time. The second movie, our Hitchcockian thing, I think we started running into some like locational prop problems.
Yeah, location issues. That's gonna take, because
we didn't have a clear ending, but that shit is whatever. It's a movie we're trying to make. We gonna have the ending. So it was between.
I'm glad you brought the locational thing, and that's another thing too. When you're creating your movie, sometimes people, when we in the creating process, they think of all these amazing ideas and not taking in. We have 48 hours in a limited space to do this. Mm-hmm. You feel me? Like that Hitchcockian idea. Everyone liked that idea, but even DC, shouts out to DC. He came through and we was looking. We was breaking down which one was simpler. At the end of the day, neither of them was that fucking simple to shoot, personally. Neither was that simple to shoot. Mm-hmm. But the first one, we required so many locations that we would have fucking ran ourselves dry trying to match them all. On top, but in a weird way, we kind of still was in that position, because we had road movie, which means you have to get on the road. We wound up having to take an actual road trip of sorts to shoot the road movie, because like Mike said, majority of the movie's in this car.
Mm-hmm. So like I guess that's a later part of Saturday, but yeah, so that was really a part of it. Like, if we couldn't get the locations to pop, or if we ran into a problem, that kind of dropped the fucking movie. So it was like, well, if we having problems, and like, you niggas seem excited, like, all right, let's go with this one. And I'm like, I'm sitting in the back like, all right, man, this car shit don't pop, I already know this shit flop. All right.
Yeah, but no matter what, we would have road movie. So either one we took, we was going to run into, if you talking about the car, having to shoot in the car, we was going to shoot in the car regardless.
I feel like for the hitchhike, we could have hopped out. The other one, I think, really locked you into being in the car.
But majority of our movie, even if we hop out, had to be
road.
You know what I mean? That's what it came down to a lot, too, because they'll fuck, like, you can play with the system, but road, like, you know what I mean, you like, because one I did, it was like, what if we just had a movie where nigga was walking a lot? I was like, well,
we tried to get cute with him.
They did. This other one where it was like this dude trying his hardest to get it on a road trip. So he's waiting. It was some shit, something I came with. I'm like, dog, why are we being so cute?
He's always getting adjacent rides to the trip.
Whatever, dog. But not even getting adjacent rides. It was like, anyway, I don't want to get that deep into it. But it came down to niggas not wanting to follow the rules. And it's like, dog, let's follow the rules. We've been doing this a long time. We have a bad win-loss record as far as getting our shit in on time correctly. You know what I mean? So can we please just get it in and get it gone? So by Friday, and it's like zombies the way people start falling off. Because did your whole team stay the whole 3 days?
No, they didn't stay the whole 3 days, man. But they you know, everybody kind of popped in and out as their schedules allowed.
So that's how it was going down. So, you know, as the night go down, you start getting down and doing it down to it's only like
a few people.
A few of us. That's why I said we don't never shoot on Friday night because the most of our shit be day shots anyway. And we usually have maybe like one night shot or two night shots. Or two shots that you can sub for night or day, but we probably at a point don't even know who's playing what to even be like, we're going to definitely shoot the end now. You know what I mean? So that's why I kind of envy that y'all was able to do that, though. That gave you a lot of space when it comes down to getting to Sunday.
Now that you mention it now, though, I wish we could have, like, kicked it around. And, like, I wish we would have kind of done, like, a little bit more of a... This is something Sorry.
That's all good,
my bad. So, party foul. And this is just an idea I'm literally just getting as you're mentioning y'all are kind of breaking down to me how y'all did y'all thing. Like for me, I was thinking, like, let's... I remember Jenny asking too, like, do you want to take a break and like start Saturday, or do you want to start shooting as soon as possible? Mm-hmm. And then I started thinking, like, you're gonna be doing the editing. You know how you edit. Mm-hmm. Slow as a motherfucker. So let's get this bitch started as soon as possible, so you can get in front of that computer as soon as fucking possible. Now, still, even though I do remember, now that I'm thinking back on it, I did take a break at some point when we did sort of, meet from that morning to the next Saturday afternoon. I did take a little bit of a nap, so I wasn't as sleep deprived as I'm thinking I was. But, you know, it was, it's just all still a blur. But,
guys make, like, shot lists or... like that shit that's supposed to help you when you're on set? Like, when you're on set, you got time. Did you do any of that?
So
y'all had the store, you pretty much were set on what locations you guys were gonna shoot at?
Yeah, I was pretty sure where we were gonna shoot.
Already there.
Yeah, we were so we shooting at Jenny's apartment pretty much, and so it was gonna kinda take place in and around there. So yeah, I just kinda mentally kept track. Like I kinda start off for the most part, like why, which is something that kind of, okay, without having much of a script, I learned we did have a script. The thing is, we did have a script, but like we encouraged them to kind of throw stuff in there. So we wound up, but at the end of the day, there was more stuff that was thrown in there than there was kind of that came from the script. Every idea basically came from the script.
Yeah.
But most of the dialogue is kind of made up for the most part, right? In different takes and whatnot. So basically what I learned was even if you don't have that much of the script, if you figure out the scene, start wide and maybe even don't shoot. Maybe even don't worry about shooting that first wide shot. For me, I don't want to be going through a whole bunch of takes that I'm not going to use. You know what I'm saying? So like, why even record those? But figure out what the scene is first. Let everybody do what they're going to do. Figure that out.
Yeah.
When it feels good, start shooting it. Then start moving in tight. Now, because of time, and in my head, I'm thinking, man, we need to hurry up. We need to hurry up. We need to hurry up. I'm like, before we figure out what the scene is, I've already shot the wide, and I'm really shot a fucking rehearsal.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I didn't really shoot the real thing.
Right,
but I'm like, God, fuck it. We got something.
Right.
Let's go. Let's move. So I'm like, let's go in, move in tight. So then you start moving in.
You're also a cameraman as well?
Huh?
You also...
I'm one of them, right?
Okay,
so
cool.
There was another cat that came through, ironically named David as well. So David, sound guy, David, the cameraman. Mm-hmm. So it's like, hey, David, sound speedy? All right, David, camera rolling? All right, cool. All right, let's go. That was pretty fun. Right. So, but what I, what was I talking about? Oh yeah, what I learned about is because so when you get to the point where you're going in tight, and then stuff kind of isn't matching, it's like, well, oh, that's because you didn't really figure out what the scene was. And then there are other times where you did stay out wide enough, and you shot every one of them, but you stayed out wide enough until you figured out what the scene was, and then you moved in and started getting coverages of this thing and that thing and that, move on, and it's like, okay, that shows.
Because what you said is exactly No. Well, that's not what I'm saying. What you're saying is the exact element that I feel like maybe I didn't get clear to you when I said how we did.
Because
I got you. You're saying of like the process, because I'm like, what you just described is what you need. What you want to gather.
But that element of knowing what the scene is important, because that will limit the amount of times where we did five scenes and these niggas think saying a completely different things all five times versus they stayed in the same area. Now they might have a different joke this time than that the next time, this and that, but for the most part, they knew I'm gonna talk about the gym, the same I'm gonna talk about the blue dog. You know what I mean? Even if they said something different about the blue dog, it was always knowing the scene helps that. And it sounds like for what happened at times for you, it would might have been completely different conversations that you having to mash together.
Same conversation, just completely different, like, takes on the conversation. It's like
different tones.
Yeah, different tones. And then, like, I mean, when I think back on it now, man, we were so loose with that script, really, I think. And that maybe kind of made it feel like it didn't have legs for a little bit, like it was kind of a little shaky, because I think, I would go back to the script all the time. The thing is, though, I would always, before we start shooting something, I would always go back to the script and just kind of get an idea of what was there and then sort of craft it from there. Because, like, the scene would be there on the page, and then I'd be, okay, well, cool. So, y'all about to see, this is what's going to happen. We're going to have y'all here, you're going to have you here, you say this, you start off here, da-da-da-da-da, and then we'll just kind of keep going. And then eventually, we'll kind of get to something that's like, okay, cool. Keep that part. Right. Let's shoot it again. All right, but we'll maybe forget the other stuff, and then boom, we'll grab it. And then once that happened, I could. But like in the very beginning, that didn't register. Mm-hmm. Like I did it absolutely the wrong way. I'm sorry. But to your question, which what I think was how you shit. I did not have a shot list, because I typically kind of go into it in this scenario. I kind of go into it the same way. Like, just start off wide, get a great master shot, and then kind of go in for your close-ups, your inserts and stuff like that. Like, that's kind of what I try to do generally in this scenario. So, like, every scene, I just kind of mapped it out that way. And then I kind of knew where we were going to be shooting. Mm-hmm. So, I just kind of, like, while people were kind of maybe chilling, hanging around, I'm, like, got the camera set up. And I'm, like, recording. I'm talking about bullshit.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Just trying to see what the frame is going to look like and stuff like that. So, I'm kind of doing that from in between. And I just keep a mental track. I didn't write anything down.
Well, here go another like flip that to throw into your mental track if you do it like that as well. When we're talking about like knowing the scene and shit. Mm. Something else, I mean, hindsight seeing from a view that could have helped you out even before that clicked, is going in as a director knowing a few options to have the actors do shit in. So just in case, like for instance, like I had one scene at DCR, he out high intense. DC, I want you to do this one cold. Just with nothing. And then I'm like, so it's like, if I give you at least three or four other versions of what you do or whatever, when you start finding the scene a bit better, finding your legs a bit better, even tone-wise, I can match you up with other things that I already put you in the lane to be on, so it won't have a problem trying to... If I like this from this and that from that, you get me?
Yeah.
So, it's built performances. Instead of getting it straight across, you're getting a slice.
But I'm saying, like, but that's that option that you know from doing this a lot.
Yeah, you know what I mean? Yeah.
Because I've made those same mistakes that you're saying. Yeah. So I'm saying it's from, but we've been doing it like this.
Yeah, you know, and it was almost like a, so I'm used to, like, on the weekends, like, I shoot at Barcadis. I don't know if I keep fucking saying that. I think I'm saying it just for Mike, basically, I guess. But on weekends, I basically shoot at Barcadia and Ohm, and it's, like, more of a, sometimes I got my steel camera in my hand, and sometimes I have my video camera in my hand.
What are you shooting?
Like, just shooting, like, the club, basically, in the back, like, we're shooting highlight reels to kind of be cut together, the music and stuff, and be posted on their social media and stuff.
Of the night?
Yeah. Exactly.
Cool. Do they ever give you a theme, or you just shoot whatever you want?
Shoot whatever I want.
By the way, the Leticia did for Raheem was pretty fucking cool. But
oh, thank you. Yeah. Oh, yeah, that came out good, man. Yeah, I'm glad. I was glad. I was a little nervous. Sorry. Here you go. But yeah, so it was also in my head, like, looking back at it, I was like, I kind of like you were in POH mode a couple times. where it was just like, I mean, this is okay, but I would have preferred you to kind of, like, I would have preferred to notice that you were in POH mode and kind of just letting the camera just drift about and do sort of, like, I don't know, man. It didn't quite work out the way I thought in my head. And, like, I just, it took me till the second day to kind of get out of that, I think. And, but yeah. Yeah, I'm sorry. I don't even know where I was going with that.
Well,
sorry, y'all.
It's all good, dog. Friday from 12 to 3, we'd like, well, whenever we really get the story, just for me to just continue forward, right. We gotta beat it down. At one point, yeah, we had this death thing that just didn't work, mm-hmm. And it was like about the intention of the character coming in the door, and then like whatever was going on. And I was like, man, that don't work. If I'm in the door, I want to kill him. So it was like, all right, until we can kill him, we can't move forward. But once we kill, like, I hate to say it, I guess that works for all our movies. Once we can kill the people, the movie about to go.
No, because yeah. Not all our movies have people dying.
I didn't want to say it like that.
Yeah,
know
what I'm saying? Uh-huh. That's not the point of it. It's more of, like, beating it to the point of you have no questions for yourself when it comes to certain shit. You know what I mean? It's like,
right.
You know what I mean? Like,
yeah, yeah.
Because the thing is, but that's still, he's
but
talking,
no, but I'm saying
he's talking more technical. Like, what you're talking is more like story on a
yeah,
level.
Yeah, I'm
of,
saying that the character death creation of the story, going back to that point, once mm-hmm. we can lock that in full on, that makes it like I can see the whole thing from start to finish. Like, I can see how this person is going to live and die. Let's go shoot it. You know
right.
what I mean?
That's, but that's your process. For me, like, I need every story beat to be clear in my head and to make sense. You know what I'm saying? If I can't make it make sense, if there's even mm-hmm. a weird plot hole-y thing, because there's no movie that's not going to plot hole.
Yeah.
Even if a movie has a plot hole, they might have a through line that mm-hmm. like you could follow the trajectory of, okay, this is the train of thought. Okay, I see where this is going. I see how this ended this way. I see why yeah. this ended this way. It might not even been plausible, but I see the A, B, C, D's is not these weird connections. So it's like, it's almost like a shot list in my brain of story.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that's an advantage of when you're also co-writing and you directing, because like what you said, since you didn't write it, you didn't have that same...
I mean, I don't want to make it seem like I was completely void in the scriptwriting process. Like I was, When I say I didn't write it, like I was very much like there. I just I went at the computer.
Let me rewrite it right. Let me restate this right. They picked one of my ideas.
Uh-huh.
So since it was one of my ideas, I had a different intimate knowledge on how to make it work than if you would have gave me your idea. And now I'm having to catch up to where your gotcha. Vision is for it.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? I think that was a better way to put it. You know
no,
what I'm saying?
True. I got you.
So, but let's move into Saturday. Because yeah. I think Friday we just basically came up with a story. We sent people about their way. We said we was going to link up 8 a.m.
Oh, so y'all didn't shoot nothing that first day. Like, nothing.
Yeah,
it was all
we hardly ever
time
shoot
and personnel
on
is always the weird thing. Because last year we had a story that kind of fit nighttime. But the people thought that we were going to be done later. Like, the story kind of came together at an earlier time. But none of the people were there.
Yep.
So we had the cheat day for night. This time it was like we expressed the need of nighttime to try to just... I mean,
daytime.
To elongate the experience to make sure we can have enough time to
and
shoot
also
coverage.
It also was gonna be harder for us to shoot a road movie
at night
without we didn't have the resources
and still
for
have,
that
because then yeah. it was gonna be like how are we gonna turn the road dark and shit yeah, yeah that's what you say
light,
yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean shooting if we had to shoot the majority of a road movie a budget because driving around would have been amazing but having to keep that lit the correct way
yeah.
and all that it,
I
it
mean
the
outside
been,
yeah yeah yeah
the outside light just helped us not have to worry about light.
We like use natural lighting, like from a lighting aspect.
This is a sexy movie. If we could have shot it first night and made a night movie, I'd have
yeah.
loved to make this a night
the
movie.
The nighttime version is like way more sinister and so like cerebral.
Yeah, man, I really wish we could have made it.
But
at night.
In trying to like shoot for light and stuff, since we don't really have a crew to carry around lights, I always try to think of how can I have the lighting be as natural as possible,
where?
Still maximize it. Like on some like. I don't know if I'm giving away cheats, but like definitely knowing your camera and your lenses,
yeah.
like of being like, oh, this can give me a low light situation for the best. But some shit just kind of like worked out cool. Like I mm-hmm. made, like our hardest part on Saturday was trying to really set up the fucking the rig for the frontal
car.
Shots.
Yep.
Like you think about that shit be easy. Like it, like we've done it before in the past and it does seem similar, but I guess every car is fucking different.
Man, they took almost an hour. Getting that bitch right.
But, like, nigga needed to really ride to, like, because we were going to not be able to jump in and intercede in any way. So, we really
I'm going to tell you about... We're going to tell you about that setup. But Friday... I mean, your Saturday. So, what went into Saturday? So, you said you shot throughout the night. And
yeah.
you was done at, like, 6 in the morning. So, your Saturday picks up at 2 p.m.?
Yeah, it was meant... Yeah, so... yeah, Rel had something that she had to do. She had, like, a show or performance or something like that. So we basically we put we were supposed to be 3, then we pushed it up to 2. to my memory, I don't think they showed up at 2. I think they still showed up at 3. So, like, we still, or maybe around 3. I can't quite remember exactly when they showed up. But they did, when they showed up, then we just kind of went on. But, like, it gave me, like, an extra, like, 30 minutes or so with her. So, but we had enough time to sort of shoot everything, shoot her out. But we just had to basically take care of, like, a couple more scenes. Like, now that I'm thinking about it, like, most of the stuff was, we were supposed to be shooting this nighttime scene, which I wasn't thinking right. I think the reason we shot that night scene, the other night scene, was because the guy that we had was, he was going to be gone the next day. So we had to shoot him out that night. That's what it was. Yeah, yeah, that's why we kept going, right?
Definitely hurts the 48.
Yeah, but you know, you understand, like, I was appreciative of everybody who, like, came in and out, man, because, like, people, like, still had work and stuff that right, they went. Right, like, right. Me and Jenny, I think, were the only ones who basically took the weekend off from work, you know, just to kind of do this, you know? So, yeah. Yeah, yeah. So I was just like, you know, we'll shoot you out whenever we can. But Saturday was basically, like, a couple more shots with Rail, which, oh, the other dude that came through, Davey, y'all were talking about, like, lighting situations and, like, knowing your camera and stuff like that. So, like, the Canon that I have, man, that bad boy is, like, a fucking dinosaur compared to the shit now. But it's, like, in low-light settings, it doesn't do well. Mm-hmm. Like, it looks great, but it just, low-light, man, it's just not the thing. And so this other guy, he had, like, a T5i or something like that. And his worked perfect, like, much light years better than mine. So, mm-hmm. like, if he wasn't there, I probably would have had to pull out, like, my other Sony, my Sony camera, which might have been able to do the job, too. But we wind up, sorry, I'm going all over the place. I think the reason I brought him up was I wanted to say, like, I enjoyed the two camera setup. Like, if I could always do that, that'd be the way I'd shoot stuff.
I want to do two camera setups in the future.
Yeah,
because it will sneakily also give you more options.
It does.
Because imagine, because there's that one scene that we were so mad that we didn't have no other options, but we would have the two camera setup.
I mean, mm-hmm. like, two camera is perfect for when we're doing stuff that's not the 48. Sometimes it gets cumbersome because you're trying to catch both of those views. But like,
you still, you saving some time when it comes to, you know, you catch that side and that front, you just make sure they angle themselves so they're not seeing each other.
Well, I guess in terms of time,
coverage and time, I'm with that. Because on Slick, since our dude Key was doing behind the scenes, he might have angles to certain scenes that we don't even know about. But it's going to look fucking different. So imagine they had the same camera, though.
I was saying, like, sometimes he might have shot other shit, like seeing the background. Like people. Like poles and shit. So that shit might have been
usable. What you about to say?
Yeah.
I burnt these waffles. I'm mad. A hard ass waffle.
That bit sound nice. And like the way you crunching it, dog.
Yeah. I'm like, yeah, you still eat that? Like, dang, it's still good though.
But I made it so I can have a snack to eat right now with you guys because I'm starving. But it's too crunchy to be being recorded and eaten. So now I'm back to being hungry. Continue.
But yeah, no, the two camera. I was gonna say the two camera setup helps also too because like. We were kind of getting different things most times. So it's like if you had two of them going and somebody was catching like a different angle, it's like, okay, cool. Now we can keep that. Mm-hmm. And it kind of like for the most part, it kind of boxed me in my like director's cut edit that had the whole thing in. Yeah. Because like what I basically did was, okay, cool. So I can cut from here to here. I got y'all, you know, I got y'all good pretty much here. And then I can cut from here to here. From that point, like I just took different pieces of different conversations or the same conversation basically, but different takes on it, and it still kind of cut together for the most part to my liking. But then at the end of the day, it was just too long. Mm. At the end of the day, we had to like chop that bad boy down.
That hurt.
And yeah,
we talked about that before about how man, son, sometimes you got to kill them babies.
Yeah,
that's so hard.
I wasn't prepared to do it though this time. It's just, that was something too. That was like a whole nother scene. It's just like, man, we had 9 minutes before that scene even gets cut into the movie. So it's like, by the time, we don't have time, it's Sunday.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? It's 3:00. So I'm like, oh man, I can't even cut this.
So y'all was editing until Sunday evening? When did y'all finish shooting?
Oh, nigga, we finished like, we finished like Saturday at some point. All right. Like,
no, they started picked up at 2.
I was rooting for you.
Midnight to 6 a.m. shooting.
I took that. They slept. Done.
They picked up shooting again at 2.
Yeah, we finished up like, ooh, Fuck, I know we finished up real around 6 or so, because that's when she had to break out. And then by the time she made it back, I know I was upstairs editing for maybe about an hour. So let's say we finished Saturday around, what, 8?
8 p.m. y'all finished shooting?
Yeah, like 8 p.m. or so.
Okay, that's not that bad. Yeah. Well, I thought I had a different thing in my head. All right, continue.
Yeah, and then so at that point, I'm like, all right, cool, let me download all the footage. And then, you know, get everybody their memory cards back, because it's like, you know, shot on, you know, different cameras and whatnot. Mm-hmm. So download everything, start looking at it, start cutting, like, Saturday night. Yeah, it's like, it was on from there. But, like, I have such a slow process, too. And then I wanted to scrub through everything to make sure I had, like, the best take, or what I thought was the best take.
Oh, yeah.
So, yeah, and I took a lot, like... And, like, you know, some of them were startups and stops. You know what I'm saying? It's just, like, you got a whole bunch of stuff there, and I want to scrub through everything just to make sure there's not, like, even a little piece of something that I can still grab. So that took a little while. That took longer because, you know, I shot a lot, and not everything was the same. So, you know, you kind of trying to keep track of all that stuff mentally, too, as well.
The fucking editing process.
Yeah. Didn't get a chance to fucking clean up the sound. So, that's gonna be one. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna take that hit. Yeah, I did, man. I was looking at it too, and then like, I barely got the credits in there right.
I mean, got like, credits. Yeah, I should blank.
Oh man,
them niggas is so congratulated. Like, thank you. We was trying to make that shit on the way on the ride, and like, I was just having problems with Premiere. And moved to do.
Yeah,
I
was like, right? I was like, your shit, like my shit crashed
really?
Three times.
Because fuck Premiere, man.
I didn't know
fuck
we,
him for real.
I didn't know we had the 30 minutes, so we were outside like at 6:55.
I mean, we didn't. None of us knew until we got inside.
I figured out that, all right, this is how we can do this shit.
I checked the website.
And so it was going to be another, really, like, and if this 30 minutes wasn't real, you'd have got there like, or we'd have walked in at like 7:12. So mm-hmm. in my mind, it was like, we disqualified with these stupid ass credits on the end of this movie.
Just for credits.
Yeah, you know what I mean?
So we was like, we ain't about to be,
I'm not about to fuck it.
Be late to get credits. Right. Everybody knew who they was, man. We're going to make it happen.
The struggle of making the 40 in the true essence of doing what the movie is, I feel like we did what the fuck, like, I wish, like what you're saying, I wish we could have, like, after we had a weird batch issue with computers and Macs, man, and Apples, man. So that shit like led to a strong ass delay.
Yeah, because I remember because what drives me sometimes when you assemble a team and you think every certain things gonna get done and then certain things don't get done. And and this time it wasn't even a person's fault. It was like he just said, the Mac and the freaking PC compatibility.
Like the way people do things, like,
and also how you do things. But I was just like thinking, okay, we need to be batching off this shit and uploading to the computer as we're shooting, so we ain't just sitting up here waiting an hour or whatever, two or however, to wait for all of these files to upload before mm-hmm. we can even edit anything. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And, you know, that kind of happened and it kind of didn't because of just certain delays and shit. But right. Saturday, we shooting, you feel me? We shot all day Saturday. We started probably shooting like around like maybe, I want to say 11. Everybody reconvened at like 8 a.m., but by the time we got everybody to the spot, I don't think we pressed record to like, what, 10:30, 11, you know what I'm saying?
It was more like 10, because we kicked that, then we had to set, we had to build that thing. That's what took a big chunk of the time, because we was on the road for like 12:30.
Build what thing? No, but what I'm saying is our first shot of the day.
Oh, yeah, probably about like 10:30.
All right, so like, yeah, and we shot in City Park for a minute. You know, that was pretty cool. You know, we got a lot of shots and stuff. Yeah. And then, like we said in the car, we did the road trip.
Means a secret park. They had this blanketed fucking past thing. I found the dumbass folder. So they had a permit for the city on like lesser known locations on some shit. But just in case.
Oh, we ain't supposed to be shooting at City Park, is what you're saying?
Yeah, on the slide. We were at Lesser Park.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know what I mean?
We was around City Park then. Okay. But anyway, so we got that bitch shot. You know what I mean? Like, as far as shooting things going, like, it was cool, dude. Like, on the overall, like, remember that thing I said I wanted to come back to? Mm-hmm. Both our actors are really good actors. Talented people.
Boom. Yeah.
One of them ain't the best at improv. So,
right.
Remember I told you, and I've gotten spoiled by some of my other ones that are really good at improv. So, when you have someone that's not that good at improv, but trying to give him the improv, because he's such an amazing actor, people got to understand, improv and acting aren't the same muscles.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Right. You have to be able to be a good actor to improv, but not every actor can improv. It's like a rapper. Not every rapper know how to freestyle. If you can freestyle, great. Not every rapper know how to, you got to be able to rap the freestyle. Can be a great rapper. No, not Blueface. They got amazing rappers. No, there's amazing rappers that can't freestyle. And there's amazing freestyles that don't make good songs. You know what I mean? So it's the same tip. So my partner, he's an amazing actor. But like that on the fly, boom, boom, boom shit, like, it's kind of tough. So then I started thinking about what you said about like, man, that we do a lot of improv. But I had to think this was both of their first times acting or working in film in a minute on some shit. So I was like, dude, like, none of the acting was bad, but it was like keeping in the head and keeping it like, so imagine this. There's a bunch of things that we have working against us. So two actors are in the car. No one else can fit in the car but the two actors and the camera and the mic. So they're in the car. I'm on speakerphone following Mike driving. I'm on passenger seat, on speakerphone trying to direct something I can't see because we don't have a monitor.
We're directing via Bluetooth.
We directing via voices. My niggas on the opposite end hear me on speakerphone, but it keeps breaking up. So it's like, again, now they have the improv, but they still have to keep all these points in their freaking head, and to keep all my directions in their head, and drive and not die, because we don't have a green screen or nothing. You niggas are actually driving, and freaking have to memorize all this shit. Because
Chris drives perfect. He never looks at it. Well, he gives some looks, but he's like, bitch, I'm trying to drive this car.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, you better not stare deeply into DC eyes and some shit while you're supposed to live while we riding back and forth. Michelle, Matt, we did a lot of fucking driving. So it was a bunch of elements of us shooting those scenes that was crazy. But for the most part, though, it was pretty fun shooting everything. It's just, again, you learn by trial and error. You learn, you know, the different things. You learn.
The car was easier than we anticipated, but I feel like that's off of growth. Like,
but if I had a monitor, there's certain things. Because there's another thing, too, about that improv shit when you don't have a script. You still got to know what things that you might, that you feel like you need to have in there. I think I said that before. Like, for this story, I wrote a story very similar to this story before. Mm-hmm. And the thing that made it work, the concept of the story, like, if you, it was one of those joints of, if you watch it twice, you're supposed to catch things because the ending kind of changes what you thought was. You know what I mean? If that makes sense.
Okay.
The beauty of those type of stories is being able to watch the movie again and catch a certain line of dialogue that might have a double meaning or a certain thing. And this is on me that I forgot that element So I'm letting them improv sometimes, and they just improv and saying random shit to get the ideas across, I guess, from point A to point B. And the shit was cool, but then for me, like, looking back when I was editing, I was so frustrated, like, damn. Where are those nuggets that, and sometimes through the improv, when you watch it again, there are natural nuggets that they did come up with without knowing it. But like this type of story, like, it reminded me why
it needed to be written.
Certain things need to be written. You know what I mean?
Well, you know, now that you mentioned, I kind of just didn't really use my brain, dude, because like there's a couple of times where like there was like an improv in my head, and I was like, okay, I want him to say this, then I want him to say this, and then I want him to say this, right? And then I want him to say this, and then she says this, and then
you
she
forgot
says this,
to tell
and then
what?
We walk away. No. What? And then they walk off frame, right? Mm-hmm. But I'm like, nigga, if you know that, then write the fucking scene.
No, but like, you can do that.
Like, you gotta write, like, it's just at a certain point, it's like, well, if you got these ideas and you want them to say this thing, then fucking write the shit down. But, and I had the opportunity to do that and didn't.
But this,
and I'm like,
you okay? You're right. First and foremost, everything you're saying is absolutely right.
Okay.
But what I'm saying, even within the improv, if they're improvising and you have something better in your head as the shooter, the director, give them the shit that you got in your head, because they're gonna make it better.
Yeah.
Because that's what I got used to. Is like, I'm a pretty good writer, and I'm pretty good at coming up with stuff on my head because I'm an improv person too, and I have a lot of people in our squad that are just naturally good at improv. You know what I mean? So if I throw them, you have to have this funny ass line in it. You gotta have this line in it. They will make sure that line's in there, and through the goodness of the line I gave them, they will naturally, being talented individuals, come up with three more based off of what you already gave. So I'm saying, son, if you had something on your brain in that moment that you could have gave them that would have been great, they would have elevated it. If you got the right people that can improv, because once again, it's a different muscle.
I'm just happy to think that you have
people that were good at improv, because a lot of times, people that are good at improv, they just need fucking material. Like, they just need gas. Throw gas on the fire, and you're going to get the right flame.
And I mean, also too, what I think I learned, and I don't know if it, I don't know. I was a little, there was one actress I was a little nervous about sort of doing improv, and I did kind of want to have sort of what I could sort of feed, lines I could feed her.
Yeah.
In terms, just in case, right?
Right, right, right.
And then turns out, like, she fucking killed it. Yeah. Like,
you know what I'm saying? That's always great.
Like, yeah, it was just like she just kind of got it. And then, like, it was like, oh, like, yeah, I was just a little nervous.
Mm-hmm.
Just a little nervous.
Well, I love when I get surprised or get right. impressed. And I'm yeah, like, damn, oh, like, yes, okay. Kill that shit.
Yeah, it was like, yeah, looking back at it, I was just like, wow, yeah, all right. Word. All right. Now I know what to, you know.
So you get, we get into the editing process, because I said, because we started.
Who did the edit?
We did the edit together. Like symbiosis. We don't like to do it like that.
But I mean, I don't know how to work Premiere, and I had the thing in my head. And Mike went, boy, Mike, you got brain dead early this year.
Dog, I just got tired, bitch. Like, dog, I was looking at the computer, and I was just like, dog, this shit is swirling in my face. It's just like,
I know.
I really just was body tired. I think at that point, I was up probably past like 15, 18 hours.
Because my thing on the time shit, dog. I like what you said earlier was absolutely true, son.
Yeah.
You need sleep to function.
Yes.
And I think for the 4D, see, this nigga here, he likes to take pride in being the nigga up the longest.
I
learned that no, you weren't. You weren't up the longest.
How so?
Nigga, you
how much did I sleep?
Son, you took 5-6 hours.
No, I didn't. How I took 5-6 hours? I slept 3 hours when we came back. We stopped at 7, we got up again at 10.
We stopped at 6, we got up again at 10, and you had those other 3. My nigga, I didn't go to sleep then, if that's the fucking case, my nigga.
I went to sleep at 7 in the morning, dog, regardless of what happened. I laid down at 7, dog.
Any fucking way, my nigga. When you put where your sleep is in a proper place, then you could better allocate it. Because that was a poor time to go to sleep at that point, but we couldn't do nothing about it because he was going brain dead. And I'm like, well, I got to sleep too then, because that's when he's sleeping, you feel me? If we both would have picked other times to sleep, then when it comes to came time to that stretch, it'd have just been a stretch. You feel me? And
how long of a break did y'all take, like for a nap?
It was 3 hours.
Nigga, it was not 3 hours, my
dog. I'm telling you, I got back to you with a 10.
It wasn't, son. I remember I'm up and I'm looking at the fucking time and my nerves getting bad, dog. And Kelly like, dude, it was not what time you thought. Whatever time you thought it wasn't, my G. And what time we stopped, I remember looking because I was sitting up at the computer Premiere pissed. Because I'm like, I don't know what to do. I don't know how to do this. And I'm looking at the phone and I'm looking at the computer. And I'm like, man, like, I wish we could just keep pushing. But if you brain dead, you're freaking brain dead. And I'm wishing that, like, you know what I mean? Like, we took time to sleep between Friday and Saturday. But I mean, like, somewhere between Saturday and Sunday, earlier, I wish there was a point to get a nap in. So when it's time to edit for the stretch, we could have edited for the stretch. Because them last couple of hours, I wish we'd have had for that final edit. That's what I'm speaking on. It's like, damn, like, I wish we could have put these other hours elsewhere so we had that cushion. Because, nigga, when we got to our final edit, when we get to, because like I said, we shot until like midnight, 1 o'clock, midnight. I'm going to say midnight. We shot till midnight, like Saturday. Then we had to wait all those fucking hours before we could freaking start freaking editing. And then by the time we started like getting into our groove, it's like 5-6 in the morning. Then we pass out. We come back at 10-11, you know what I mean? More like 11, more close. It's really close, getting close to 12, you know what I'm saying? It's like 11-ish. You know what I'm saying? And my nerves getting bad because the closer we get to 12, the closer we get to, oh no, it's not morning anymore. And when it's not morning, then it's afternoon and then it's evening. And I'm like, when it's morning, I'm still feeling like it's morning. Like, it's, bitch, 7 o'clock is a far off from morning. You know what I mean? But it starts getting really close to you when you get to after 12 in my brain. You know what I'm saying? So we editing, we editing, we editing, and we editing, we editing, we editing, we editing, we editing, we editing, son. And we got that bitch done. I mean, it maybe like three hours before the deadline. You know what I mean? We had about 3 or 4 hours before the deadline, we had a version of it. You know what I'm saying?
Cool.
Surprisingly, it was naturally 7 minutes.
And that comfort I had was from the planning we did. And when we talk about shit and just like, it's out here. But like for other people to read it, you know, you got to type it up. Lawrence turned that turned that vomit into like actual text. So like I think that let us go to sleep better on the Friday going into the Saturday. It was like, this bitch 3 pages. I was like, ooh, but it could be a sneaky 3 pages.
But once we got down to the editing, it was 7. I was like, all right. Yo,
7 is like on
that bitch was sitting inside the cradle. Like, we could just trim some scenes. Like, not even trimming fat, but just like little breaths of bullshit just that they ain't even necessary. Like, what? Do you need to walk in this door or be in the room? Shit like that.
Fucking premiere, son.
Started dying on
that
us.
Did that bitch crash on y'all too? It crashed 3 times on me, bro.
Gion's computer had so much shit on it that it was glitching. Was your shit doing that skipping shit?
Yeah. Oh, it was like,
oh, God.
Every single time, it was like, I gotta ignore it. Because you had to fucking push through and ignore it. Oh, you couldn't watch the playback.
I missed iMovie, son. I missed the fuck out my iMovie.
That, bro.
I missed iMovie, son.
I wasn't hurt.
iMovie, it's simple. It's simple. It's simple, son. Premiere got way more options. I love that. But
and I know how to use it like a 16-year-old.
But my iMovie is blub 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 blub. Not let me move this audio track over and let me move this right here. Let me wait for this to glitch and
I've got the audio track locked up, thrown off the rim.
Nigga, dude, it was driving the fuck out of me, dog. And again, I'm just using my hands. It's Mike's hands, and I'm like, oh my god, we can't do anything else. And I can't. What I'm gonna do? Move his hands faster. He has to do these steps. They're required steps to do all this shit. And he can't help. That shit is glitching.
When
I'm like, tired,
like, he would be like running me some shit. And I'm just like, dog, I heard the sequence. I can't find this shit. Like, we had like a, it wasn't a data. It's back to the data shit, but it's like, you kind of like, he told me this, and I guess I got to just do this. You got to write the shit down on paper, how you do it, and pass the nigga your paper. Like, you're doing what I do. Boop. And then like, when you come to it, it's gonna be what you said, but not even being mean. Just on like, not everybody has the same process, and I can see how everything could be different, but it's like, it's just everybody does different shit. To get what you want, you really have to just slide that shit over to people, and you know.
Your editing process was a bitch, dog. Well, so what happened by the time you got to the end of it? Like you said, so how long was your actual movie?
Oh man.
Like the one that they got.
So what happened was
you got within the seven though.
Oh yeah, I definitely got within the seven. Yeah. But oh, you know what? Yeah, I'm sorry. That's probably what it is. So because what I did was the time. Oh man, dude, doing this shit for the first time, man. I really took risks for granted in that sense. Cause like he got all this shit. Like you got to push it back 2 seconds. Like the first time I rendered it, I watched it. And I'm like, nigga, that went 2 seconds. And I'm like, no, that's point 2 seconds, you just moved it. You gotta move it back actual 2 seconds. Oh. And I'm like, all right, cool, let me do that. And da 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 da. But it's like, ah, oh, dude, it just, the whole thing was it felt rough. I don't know, like when I first, so here's the thing. I put the movie together. I did my sort of whole cut, and then that whole initial cut was like 9 minutes and some change. Mm-hmm. Like 9 minutes, 28 seconds, something like that. So then it became like, okay, I know I'm going into 8 minutes. I remember being at 8 minutes at some point, but I'm like, okay, I'm just going to keep going, and then I'll get my whole thing out there, and then we'll go back and then start trimming stuff. And by the time I got to the whole thing, I was just kind of like, I thought I had an edit that I liked. I showed it. I watched it back for the first time with everybody, and I was like, and I was just like, there was just certain places where I was just like, okay, I wasn't very communicative on the first couple days, like the first couple shots. I didn't really communicate well sort of what I wanted or sort of what it was kind of, what was sort of happening there. I didn't facilitate what was happening there well. So what wound up happening was I put the scene in there and it kind of worked. There was a cut in it that I really liked. And but we wind up having to cut the whole thing really and just sort of start the movie a little bit further into it. And that was something that I learned in the editing process that, oh man, you gotta, the points where I figured out, you know, the thing I said earlier, like, you know, start wide, figure out what the scene is, or really figure out what the scene is first on what you're gonna do in terms of blocking, because things become, I don't know. It's like everybody really tried to be conscious of continuity. I want to give everybody credit to that.
Yeah.
But then there just were just certain moments where I'm like, you were real relaxed into it this time, and I got a great take, but it's not going to match up with anything else. Yeah, or you in this spot. Too. Yeah, and it's just like, I have no way of cutting around it so I can use the one I want.
That's why I knew use another one. You better marry a new one, bitch.
Yeah, no, I mean, but sometimes even with that, you can cheat like a cross body, because like if the two people talking or like I could reverse, he's like he's on the phone. If you can't really see their lips, you can include their actions, their speech dialogue. If it's really that important, let's find a mask basically to put for that shit.
They had this one cheat on ours where I really liked this one take that DC did, the one on there's one version of it, but for the scene to make sense. Mm-hmm. I couldn't use it because the vibe was so different from what was happening in the scene that I had a cheat to make it work, but it added so much time for that to have a natural elapsed period for him to calm down, basically, that it would have fucked us. You know what I mean? So that's one of those ones where I feel like you could cheat. I feel like if you look back at it, there's probably ways to cheat it, but it's a cheat. It's not what you wanted. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Organically.
Right.
But yeah. So Jenny told me to ask you a story. Jenny told me to ask you a story. So let me see what she told me to ask you.
Jenny.
She said, make sure you ask Marty.
Oh, Lord.
What story this is?
Bro, I was gonna tell it to you.
Also, it's just a side note.
Oh, you already know what I'm talking about? Come run it. What's that?
Maybe.
Okay, shit. I don't know if we're supposed to be kicking knowledge or whatever, but extra shouts out to Keith from Comfy Stones, man. After me and B had ranted about, I thought homie was like cameras and lights, but he was like, nah, dog, you get on the camera. Homie came through on the lights, like, in a major way. So that was super.
Word.
Like, I gotta give this man mad respect, and he was really, like, grinding it out with us, like, because he had to shoot all the shots with us. So he really ran with us at the same time. So that's mad appreciative. Yeah. For him coming through. I just, you know, he might not even hear this, but I just wanted to say that. But
shout out. We giving shout out to crew members. That's what we're doing. Let me do that too.
I mean, go for it. Shout out, but it was a shout out to something something learned, but dealing with lighting, but never mind.
Tell us about the learned experience.
Never underestimate. I think it was you talking about two cameras, but just even having your own camera, even if you're like you got a guaranteed shooter. Because it's like, ain't nobody said you can't shoot your own shot, but then you might have this, like, you might be standing by the money shot. Like, oh, you, that's all you need is a camera.
Oh, shit, y'all had, man, we just cross-pollinating. He did that. Y'all had David Regis on your team?
Yeah.
He did that David too.
Yeah, he was a sound dude. That's why I was going to share. Shout out to
him because he worked for us. Damn, I just saw him pop up on the picture. Yeah, this nigga's been on our team so many times throughout the years,
dog.
Yeah, he
said he worked with y'all before.
Yeah, they cool.
But yeah, he did sound. Didn't really have a chance to mix most of it in. Like, it would have came in handy too in a couple spots. But I did not have the time. Like, there was music. Like, our music guys, shout out to Nice and Easy for doing music, being in it and doing the music, right?
Yeah.
And they stuck around, too, for a little bit to try to kind of get a help with the editing, what could be cut. Because, like, I'm sitting there looking at the 9-minute stuff and then looking at the scene where they're sitting down talking. And the reason the cuts are how they are because this is how I could string together this conversation.
Yeah.
It's not maybe necessarily the shots I want it, but it does string together the conversation, you know. So I just didn't know how to really cut at that, but then they kind of came at me with a couple ideas and stuff like that about what to do. So, you know, it was a bit of a collaborative process on the edit after, you know, sort of that longer cut. And
nigga, any crazy shit happen? On y'all team, because this year we all
not think, on the team, no.
I mean, like, because you know, I mean, it's like some years we just some random occurrence just usually might happen. I can't think of no crazy shit.
I had some shit at Turning that I was gonna tell y'all about, but it's like the more and more I think about it, man, I was like, damn, nigga, who are you?
Like, what are you
talking about? What? Yeah, I know, right?
Martin Bass Bradford, please make sure Marvar Edwards tells you the story of how he almost got me beat up at the 48-hour film drop-off. Is it the same story or is it
that's
different?
The same story.
Oh, Lord, would you look at that.
Let's bust it open, right?
Nothing crazy. Fuck them in their paper and shit.
That was
did y'all get fucking ass on that shit too?
You had papers?
Yeah, we had fucking papers. What? The fucking same blue folder, bitch. We like, nigga, what the fuck?
Why do you make papers printable if you don't want them to be printed? Why are they printable if you don't want them to be printed? And after, and I will say this, Marty, they have never, every year, they make you print them fucking papers off.
They told me at check-in. Did they not tell you at check-in, bro, that you gotta, like, so they said something about a digital, okay, wait, no, wait, time out. They said something about a digital shit, but then they said, absolutely, you can also, it was, that's absolutely what they said. That's what they said. And then they're like, okay, you can put it on here, or you can just do the printout like we always do, which I'm like, okay, cool, because you're going to find all those things on the website, you know, blah, 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 blah. So I'm like, all right, cool. We gonna have it printed out.
That's fuck what they this told digital you, shit. My nigga.
The fuck bitch, this digital shit. They said either or.
The lady struggled finding my name. I told her I was in the first group. She passed me the thing. When she said what you said, I thought she was saying, like, you know, you're gonna put your movie on the hard drive.
My nigga, no pause. Yeah. We damn near dancing in that motherfucker. We so on time.
Yeah,
we ain't got, because there have been times where we rendering inside that bitch still trying to get our movie off.
That's,
you know what I mean?
The last 2 years.
Niggas, so we like, I mean,
y'all edit on the laptop?
We done PC this year.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, PC too.
But
yeah,
we've done it on laptop before. Okay. I'm saying, so we strolling that bitch. I'm holding Mike's son and shit. I'm like, we in this bitch. In this bitch. So Mike giving the lady the shit, the paperwork.
Right.
And she looking our stuff up. And I'm with the kid. And I'm feeling like, wait, why she taking so long? What's going on?
Wait. This chick handed me like, I gave her the paperwork, right?
Yeah.
This chick handed that shit back to me. And I'm like, what? And I'm like, all right, I guess she don't want it right now. No, she did it so casual too. Hold on to that. I'm like, okay, cool, I'll hold on to it. Maybe I walk down here a little further and give it to these folks. I'm like, all right. Okay, cool. And she's looking for the fucking files on the hard drive. And I'm like, it's a brand new hard drive, nigga. That shit is fresh out the packaging.
Yeah.
So like, I plug it into the computer. It's got some SanDisk folders or some shit on it. And she's trying to click at the SanDisk folders and shit, saying it's taking a while. I don't know what's going on with it. What's that? Like she's looking for the files inside of these brand new, you know, SanDisk files or whatever, right? So she's like, I don't know. It's not coming up. And I'm like, the first thing she told me is that, oh, your movie's cool. It's fine. Okay, cool. All right. Just wanted to make sure. And then she starts clicking on others. And she's looking, trying to get into these folders. And I'm like, is there supposed to be something else there, ma'am? And by the end of the time, she realizes that there isn't anything there. Right? And the lady next to her is trying her best to tell her, no, it's a brand new hard drive, son. Yeah, it's new. They put those on all of them. Oh, but I can't find this folder. I can't find it. And I'm like, ma'am, is there supposed to be something else on there?
Right, what else?
And she's like, I can't find it. I'm like, all right, cool. Right, so I'm talking to myself. Mm-hmm. So she realizes that I don't have, she's like, okay, well, you can scan them and then go down there and talk to those people and just email them to us. And we'll put a bunch of files or whatever. They told us the same shit. Yeah.
After 10 minutes of deliberating, trying to figure out some shit.
And we like, are you about to DQ us
right over this damn
thing?
I'm like, I'm about to blow
paperwork.
Up.
Nah, not, nigga, I'm like, y'all better take this paperwork.
I need my fucking money back right now. I need $150.
Nah,
fuck, how do y'all feel about this movie? Because this shit's stupid, G.
I want to hear the story of Marty fighting niggas at the drop-off. That's what I want to hear.
Yeah,
I'm Marty dropping niggas at the drop-off, nigga.
That's when you bring us some of that Tennessee crunk right there.
Goddamn thug Marty thought he had his braids still.
Oh, he did think he still had his braids. That nigga, who that nigga think he is?
Lord. All
right, man. So I did some foul shit. I feel like now that I'm thinking back on it with some sleep. With some sleep in my body, I did some foul shit. I'm not going to lie. Marty was a, it was a jerk move, bro. It was a jerk move. Yeah, me that big shot, that brother, I think I need a swig. Bye, tell the story. Because I'm thinking about it, man, and I'm like, man. Okay, so. It's like, I hope y'all laugh too. Because I told this at the rap party when we were, me and Jenny had came back, like I was telling this story. So we go in and we look on the website, or at least I look on the web. I'm periodically looking on the website because, like I said, it's my first year doing an edit. I didn't know, it's the hardest for me to find that fucking, doop, the thing that you're supposed to put above it.
We struggled.
Like, you struggle too? Yeah. I'm like, they don't make that shit easy to find. And I had to scroll through a bunch of shit.
You're just supposed to I think they put it more prominent on the website before the competition starts. And when it does, they take that shit down.
Oh, you're talking about the video clip that you got to put before your movie?
Yeah, okay. I couldn't find that bitch, right? So that's how I knew that it was 7:30. Because when I was checking shit out, they were like, drop off 7:30. I'm like, oh, 7:30? All right, y'all, we got extra 30 minutes.
Right.
All
right.
So ooh, like we were on the market. I think we got there like 7:27.
Yeah, I'm sorry, dog. I've been fucked on 7. I'm like, bitch, it's 7.
You're like, yeah.
I don't give a fuck.
Right?
I told 5, I was like, but son, they didn't let us go to 7:30, so they owe us 30 minutes.
Yeah, exactly. No, they were off on a mug, but like, Dan felt like there was a ton of groups, though, man. They was fucking pulling forever, nigga.
That's
like,
a lot
forever.
Of films they got their shit in.
Well,
some people don't know they can turn their shit in late and they still gonna play them, though.
Yeah.
You're not contention.
Yeah, but, so, okay. So, we get in there, and we take the, like, that back side entrance or whatever, right? Where, like, the tables and stuff are.
Yeah.
So, we head over to the table, not really noticing that there is a line formed behind us, right?
Yeah.
So, we go straight up to the table. And we stand in there, right? And we're like, yeah, all right, cool, yeah, feel good, we made it.
Vision.
All right, cool.
Right.
You know, cool. All right, we good. So at some point, Jenny notices that there's a line formed over there. But when I first get there, I'm like, I'm not even paying attention to that shit. I'm just looking like, oh, fuck, there's really nobody here. I was like, I don't see bats anybody. I don't see, like, that's how I text. I was like, y'all get y'all stuff in? I didn't see y'all at all. Whatever. But, yeah, y'all turned y'all shit in early.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So,
what do we got there for you?
Yeah, you got there for me. Like, well, I tell you, nigga, 7:27, we walked in that door.
Ooh,
right?
I
so,
like that.
No, it was. But, yeah, I was speeding, bro. But, so, we stand in there. Jenny notices that there's a line form behind us. I'm like, well, if ain't nobody gonna say nothing, I'm just gonna walk up to this table.
Right.
All right, unless ain't nobody gonna say nothing. Just kind of turned around. I was like, nobody say nothing. Okay. So, Jenny is like, okay, well, I'm gonna go stand. Wait, outside.
Right.
She's like, I don't want that smoke. So I'm like, all right, cool. So I step up to the table, right? After this guy, there's like two or three like receiving areas. So I step up when the guy walks away. So then this other cat, like, was over here, what I'm thinking was just gonna, you know, slide up to this person, decides he's gonna slide over to this side. Because, like, nigga, you just walked up here,
yeah.
Right? So he comes over and he kind of pushes, you know, like, hey, man, you like, okay, so, bro, I'm gonna stop right now and say, I do not remember what the man said to me. Like, nigga, when I tell you, all I can hear was that Kill Bill theme playing in my head when this nigga was talking. Beer, 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 beer. Nigga, my eyes turned into some anime shit. I'm like this on this nigga. Like, I'm like, ooh. So I take a swift second. And I'm like, like, I don't do that. But I'm just, you know, in my inner voice. And I'm like, okay. That wasn't the way to do that, but I just want you to know you almost got your ass whipped on that, bro. I just want you to know that. And he starts telling me, you know, like, yeah, you cut the line. Yeah, nah, I understand that. I get it. But just that shit there, yeah, it almost got your ass kicked. All right, just
so
want you to know
touch
that.
You?
He just kind of pushed me to the side, like, he touched me, yeah.
So
but he just kind of.
His body to push you out the way?
Yeah, the edge in, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
So I would just tell them, like, don't, well, fair enough. So I told him. That almost got your ass whipped, and I walk
and
away.
You told him that.
No, that's what I said. Yeah,
verbally,
yeah, I said that almost got your ass whipped.
That's my nigga.
And then I walk away.
I don't care what you about to say, Marty. That was G.
Okay. Now wait.
Keep it going. I'm sorry.
Wait. What everybody has to take in though is
you was wrong.
I was fucking wrong.
You skipped.
I skipped.
Yes, but guess
right?
what? No. But that's what this was. You have to take in, Marty. There is no reason this man should have touched your being or your body.
If
he touched your body, if he came into your personal space.
It wasn't even a hard shove. I don't want to make it seem like it's more than it was. It wasn't even a hard shove,
it's
brother.
A simple,
it
excuse
wasn't.
Me.
Okay.
I would rather you say, excuse me.
Right.
Than to come in my space in any passive aggressive manner. That's
yeah.
what I'm saying.
Okay.
Maybe you telling him that he almost got his ass whipped under normal human being social interaction might have been a bit harsh crossing a certain line, but this guy right here to the left of you feels like the fact that he came into your personal space grazed any of that bullshit, he crossed the line his damn self, and it could have been done a different way. That's what I'm saying. That was G, but continue.
Okay. So I went back to the end of the line. I'm like, all right, I'm gonna take that and I'm gonna go to the end of the line. I'm like, I didn't let it go by without saying nothing. I didn't hold that in and walk to the end. I you know, said my piece and went to the end of the line. What, boom, boom.
Was he white?
Yeah, he was white. Oh, yeah. Yeah. I probably, like, no, but I probably wouldn't have did it if he was black. I probably wouldn't have just let that go.
I'm just saying, but the fact that you said the point is pushed over.
Right, fair enough. So the point is, like, the point is I was wrong. And I go to the end of the line, you know? And Jenny comes back. And I'm kind of steaming a little bit still. I'm not going to lie. I'm a little steaming. So Jenny comes back and she sees me at the end of the line. She's like, oh, what happened? And I'm like, yeah, I almost kicked somebody's ass just now. And she's like, what? Who? I was like, that motherfucker right there. I almost kicked his ass right there. And I'm like, that's why I'm just like, man, this was like you.
I was being a dick.
Yeah, I was in full dick mode, bro. Known. It was a dick move. When I say it was a dick move, it was a dick master move, nigga.
That's why they call me Evil Marty, because I guess I'm a dick.
My nigga. So Jenny stands there with me and she's like, you know, she rubbing the nigga back. She's like, calm down, it's okay, you know, blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, nah, it's cool. It's not that, like, it's not even that thing. Like, you know, he said his piece, I said my piece. Like, I came to the end of the line, you know, he's about to check in or whatever. We all good, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah.
Or whatever, right? Now, at that point, there could have been an apology in the future. Mm-hmm. Like at this point in the course of the story, there could have been an apology. Now he is owed one, mm-hmm. but there could have been one, right? Now,
what?
Now, so the line, you know, kind of dies down or whatever. I finally make it to, you know, I'm at the front of it,
front of the line,
about to check my stuff in. His girlfriend comes over, and she's like, did you tell my boyfriend you were going to kick his ass?
Ooh.
And I'm like, yeah. Your boyfriend wasn't, like, I forget what I told her. Like, something like your boyfriend was an asshole over there. He wasn't polite. He wasn't nice. He's like, he nicely told you that you were cutting the line. He nicely told you that.
And pause. You didn't say you were going to kick his ass. You technically said that was got your ass.
That's
it.
That was with my exact words.
Those
yes.
are two now, different things.
But no, but there are whatever.
Two different things.
What, like for me, you, in that moment, close enough.
Nah. I mean, I'm saying as your lawyer, one is okay. a threat. One is an one. Actual threat of this is something I'm going to do.
Right.
And the other one is, ooh, you missed the bullet.
This is what you worthy of. This was what I'm about to give. Bullet.
But good to see you, sir.
So she's going off. She's like, you're gonna threaten him with fucking violence? Like, are you fucking nuts? And like, she's, you know, she's going off and she's telling me like, you know, you better not say you're gonna kick his ass. He's the nicest guy in the world. And we're like going back and forth, and she's like, he's been up 48 hours. And I'm like,
me too, bitch.
Like, we have all been up 48 hours. But in my like head, I was just like going to so many places. Like, is that the excuse you tell at his day job? Like, he's been up for 48 hours making a movie. Like, that shit is cool to them. But nigga, we all in the same fucking boat. I'm in the same place. But anyway, if we didn't have, and Jenny's trying to de-escalate the situation. That's the point where she's telling you, because she stayed with me up until the walk up. So she missed the interaction, but she came back for when the girlfriend came up. She was there. So she's like, you know, look, we understand. Like, Jenny's really like, you know, nice about it. Like, hey, listen, we understand, but you're only making the situation worse doing this. Mm-hmm. Okay, so why don't, you know, it's cool. Look, hey, listen, you're only making it worse. And I'm like, okay, well, you know, because this chick, she goes into the fact that she's a kickboxer. And I bet not say I'm going to kick anybody's ass around her. Because apparently, seemed like she was square. She was ready to square up right then and there. And so, at some point, she's like, she goes away. She goes back over to her boyfriend. And they're over there talking or whatever, what have you. And
what was he doing this whole time?
Nigga, he's like way the fuck over by the tables and shit.
So he's a whole hoe out here. He ain't just a half a hoe. He a whole hoe out here.
If Jenny wasn't there, I swear to God. Well, no. You know what? That's not right. I'll
he
tell you
a whole. What type of nigga okay. is you?
So
you
wait.
Left what?
Wait,
you
no, did? Wait. I was. Continue, my G. Sorry, I was in dick mode. But look, listen. So yeah, she's gonna threaten. She was like, she was gonna kick our ass or whatever. And that's, you know, that's what Jitty's talking about. She was like, I'm not gonna let her kick your ass. I would have taken the beat down for you. I was like, nah, I wouldn't let you do that. I appreciate you though, dog. But I wouldn't have let it go down like that. But yeah, so she goes back over and we're going to turn in our paper, right? Mm-hmm. So one of the chicks, like, I don't know, like, she's got like a, this is, I don't know, this is just where it is. She's got like a tattoo here, mm-hmm. and she's like behind the counter. She sort of like, she says hi. She takes, you know, she knows all the turning people and stuff. So they're over there talking to her. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? And I kind of got the impression that they knew each other. Mm-hmm. Just saying. So I'm I turn in my paper, right? I turn in my paper, and that girl comes over and takes the first page mm-hmm. with my name and everything. I think it's like the certification or whatever page or whatever. Mm-hmm. She takes it. She walks over. She goes and she writes something down.
Oh, no, bitch. What you doing my name?
And then she goes back and she gives it to her. Now, I didn't hear what she told her, right?
Yeah.
Now, and I'm trying hard, too, but I didn't catch it. But Jenny heard, don't allow something. Don't allow anything after. Don't allow something. Like, she heard, don't allow. That's the only defining thing she heard. Don't allow.
Did you get pulled in?
Maybe. Damn. I don't know. And that was the thing. In hindsight, it was not worth it to get my whole team and everything that they sacrificed, like, kicked out because I just, like, couldn't hold my shit together for 5 seconds. You know what I'm saying?
That seems random as fuck, though, G.
Man, yeah. Look. Okay, I wish, ladies and gentlemen, that you're listening right now. I wish you guys could see Marty right now. He is such a good person. Cause
not in this story though.
No. I wish y'all could see him as he tells this story. He is so pained by every bit of telling this story. He's pained. Like, you should see his, he's like, he has no joy in this story. He feels so bad that he allowed himself, et cetera, et cetera. I'm listening to this story, ladies and gentlemen. Like, my nigga, you handled that so much better than me. Because one, I'm going to say this as a preface. That's not your fault if y'all get disqualified. There's no way for you to have known that these people had these connects. And if that girl got you DQ'd, that's some whole politics bullshit. Because, my nigga, even if you did say, I'm going to fuck you up, that ain't got nothing to do with what's going on over here. Because no one asked you anything. No one talked to you. No one got your side of any story. So if they really DQ'd you, I would be like, prove that something happened. What are you talking about? All you saw was me and this girl argue. If this girl movie is in and yours is not in, and she participated in the argument, she made a fight happen that did not have to happen. You over here done. He was over there done. She threw gas in a situation that didn't have nothing going on. So if they ain't DQ'd too, then your movie can't be DQ'd. She can know whoever the hell she want to know, son. I would fight that shit tooth and nail if they tried to pull some shit. But even as I hear your story, I'm like, dude, this woman right here, son, I guess I would have gotten my ass kicked. Okay? I do not hit women. I do not throw anything about violence towards females. I'm not saying to put my hands on this lady. What I'm saying is the moment she would have told me, I bet not. .. I bet not what? I'm like Marty when you say chicken on Back to the Future. At a point, if you gonna be telling me, I bet not, especially like contextually, like I said, we all at this wit's end. We've all been up all this time. Yeah. And I'm sorry, man. Like, I asked you if the dude was white, dog. Like, there's certain situations that be... No, there's certain situations that be happening, dog, that be on some bullshit for real, son. And I'm sorry, dog. I ain't letting you no color just like disrespect me, but like there's this certain, I don't want to say the word privilege, but in there, dog, there was something that struck me as racial in your whole story. The fact that that girl came through at you like that, like that whole thing, just not like it was a racist story. There's power dynamics at play here that I ain't fucking with, if there's an easy way to say it. Was this girl white?
Like, she might have been mixed with something.
Did she look white? Did she present white?
Yeah.
Your average like, person, she's accepted. You'll be like, either way it goes, it son, be. Motherfucker, she knew that she knew you couldn't do nothing to her. So she made an epic story, an epic thing.
Yeah. Nigga ain't trying to about to fight the woman. I'm just saying, right. Bro, you ain't about to tell me I bet not near nothing and expect me to just be like chilling, which obviously you were, because you
like the only that was the only way to get her the fuck away. She kept going a little bit, and it's kind of like, don't know, like in dick mode, I need that last word.
Yeah.
And she was like, okay. So,
and that's the answer, right?
I'm like, how can I really piss her off at her boyfriend? And I'm like, and I'm looking over at that motherfucker, like not even looking over here while she going off. And then I was like, you can fucking hit on her right now, man. Like, tell her something. Like, tell her that dude or something. Like, just say anything to her. Like, tell her that this relationship she ain't working out for. Look how worked up she is. Tell her, look, why don't I buy you a beer real quick? Look, you tell me all about it, whatever. Like, in my head, I'm thinking, like, let me fucking do this shit right now. But I didn't say nothing.
That's what I said.
I'm just like, I'm telling y'all, I'm in dick mode.
My dog. Dude said, dick is don't look. My says, I ain't put on the dick costume in so long, but I know what it fit. It still fit what I wanted to, bitch. Don't make me go places I roamed.
But silence was pretty much the only way to get her to walk away. So, you know. Jenny told her, you know, okay, we understand. And she just, you know, kept going.
No, you guys are the shit. I swear to God, dog. Because I know the way my tempo is set up, dog. Bro. Like, I don't, you know, personally, you know what? I've grown a lot. But I really don't know where I would have went, dog. If white boy would have pushed me out the way, and I let you get there, my nigga, and then your girlfriend come threatening me about I can't tell you. Like, I think that's the part that pisses me off. Exactly. Fuck what she doing. She is telling me I can't tell you nothing, and you over there. That whole dynamic would have had me also like, the fuck?
Like, bro, this is gonna be one fun ass screening, man.
Yo,
you gotta get out of my face. Cause number one, the man week is a motherfucker. So that means you ain't strong neither.
Like, that's what you thinking, like, right? But man.
Alright. Hey man, that's so random. Like, I was not expecting that to be the story. Like, at all. What? But I just, I don't know, dog.
What happened when people look, actually, and Rocky, like, he ain't
another look to get to you. Like, oh, like, yeah. Fucking right. But nah, man, like, fucking having people do other shit, free up some shit, makes you a little smoother. Like, I think, like, the main thing is just trying to get your storyline jumping on trying to make it or whatever. And, I guess, being refreshed or having, I guess, that got to be a factor on the clock. Like, boom, nigga.
It's 2 o'clock and that's the certain nap time.
Yeah.
If you've been up since like, you know, fuck, if you've been up since 8, nigga, you gotta take a nap.
Like regardless, you know, you gotta at least take a 3rd, come back. But you're trying to just make shit happen.
Man, that shit, like, what y'all, did it autosave when it crashed on you, or did y'all?
Man, when that bitch was telling me words about the crash, I would hit control S, nigga. Fuck that.
Right.
Just like, still like, bitch, I'm about to hit save.
It was weird, though, because, like, I set my tower up at Jenny's, mm-hmm. and I forgot my fucking headphones, and then the ones I had, they weren't charged up. So, like, I had to play it out of the TV, which I'm like, I learned too. Another thing was, bro, I can't edit with, like, people, like, talking to me and shit.
Oh, yeah, no, nigga, that's, you never be listening, dog. I'm so serious. I'm really got to tell people. My son poked all over me. I was like, but you gonna be poking this shit out of me, nigga. We about to do this shit. I don't give a fuck. Draw me, do whatever. Do what you need to do for me to do what I need to do. That bitch could have been on fire right here. Unless they heat was bothering me. It got buku cold in the house, bitch. We put jackets on. Just sat right there. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
When the words started moving on the screen and I knew the fucking words wasn't moving, I was like, man, fuck, I'm just fucking rocking back and forth. And like, at least the edit, you know what I mean? I'm hearing what he's saying, but like, at least like, all right, man, he'll do a section, I could do a section or some shit like that. Like, you know, he's trying to see some shit, I'm trying to see some shit. Nigga, with no power, I can't see shit. I'm just like, bitch, what? Yeah. What you want me to do? Oh, what? With the clip? Oh, all right. What? You know what I mean? And that's like, that's not really helping. And I'm just like, bitch, I'm trudging along before I just like fucking die. And then sometimes we have like a little 10-minute fucking silence. Well, not 10 minutes, but like, a silence to take me out. Like, oh, we being quiet? Like, I'm dopey falling asleep. Like, I'm not, no. So I just need to fucking refresh. But once I took the nap, man, I could bounce back. Like, let's get it done. Like, we had a weird-ass fucking... Like, that bitch is like... You know, you start feeling like you about to... Like, oh, I'm about to be finished. That bitch, like, the program, like, oh, bitch, I'm about to click out. Like, oh, yeah, you've been on me for 24 hours. You ain't know 25 is the one where I go crazy. Like, what? So...
It didn't auto save one time, bro, and I swear.
Oh, I didn't like that no more, dog. Like,
what? What you mean? You don't have it auto save no more?
It does auto. That shit works or whatever. I do everything in like loops. So I'm like, man. I'm trying to think. Like, so you can see it, like, well, off from our movie, like. I guess like the opening sequence, you know, we put that shit in later. The shit after that, like the very first, like after the title's caught, like after we laid down like maybe 3 or 4 of the frames, like 1, 2, 3 cuts, save. 1, 2, 3 cuts, save. So like, I'm like, that's just programmed in my hand to just be like, hit control S, you know what I mean? Cause like sometimes when you're trying to like, think of an idea, how you want to cut it on the timeline and shit like that, control S, save. Like, you know what I mean? If I like experiment with some shit, control S, save. The only problem you have with that is that like, if you're doing undo, that could get zoinky. Cause you like trying to undo, you might undo, like not undoing your save, but you might not have something that like, you save some shit that you undid.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, so, I've done that before. Like I imported some shit.
Yeah,
like,
so like
transitions and shit, and then you undo it and it's like, that shit went away. Wait, no, I meant to undo on the timeline.
Yeah, you know what I mean? So like that's the fucking rule of that. But just overall, just in doing some shit, especially if like if we had somebody, that's what we didn't have. We have someone lay down rough cut. Like once you get the like, even if it's super shitty, I mean like dog, this shit looks stupid. Like, cool, we got something we could cut into and really add to the body. So we kind of were like actually cutting the film that people were gonna see. And like, you know, like cutting in the marble. I told that to my girl and she didn't know what the fuck I was talking about. But I guess you do now. But like, you know, it starts as this big stupid block. And right. You gotta fucking work that bitch to have a nigga face or a ear or some shit. You gotta really, you gotta sand the fuck out some stone. So, you know what I mean? That's what we pretty much was doing, man. Just trying to fucking finesse that bitch. Oh,
all right.
So keep talking.
I'm gonna say we're gonna just pick it up on here because I don't know what I could delete off the other thing. But all I'm saying is all I'm saying is like, yeah, dog. Like, that's why you was talking about how you don't know if you're gonna be able to do it next year because it's bullshit.
Yeah, it's kind of like I don't know, man. Because like I don't know what repercussions. Because in my head I was like, well, shit, anything is possible. Then I was kind of telling it at the rap party. I was telling the story at rap party, and Rel was telling me some stuff about y'all, which. I was just kind of like, I guess it is possible then. Well,
like what?
Sorry, y'all. Like, I don't know. She didn't go into detail. That's what I'm saying. She just kind of mentioned, like, something. She just said something like that. I guess nothing really like that happened. Maybe it was a misunderstanding or whatever.
I was having a fight, an argument.
Have you ever had something like that?
I don't remember going off on nobody.
Man, maybe, like, the first time when we, like, did that, like, when it was like, oh, you left and you came back with a thumb drive bullshit.
No, I'm talking about getting into it with somebody.
That was a fight, cause we was like, yo, that's some bullshit. But that's like that's something I could be like.
I have no recollection of it.
Of you mean like just argue like with the person in the place?
Yeah.
Nah, I don't think so. We be pissed off on our own. Nigga don't want nothing with us. Like we be looking like angry bees just sitting in the corner and shit. They be trying to come console us and.
But I don't. Stop, dude, I'm gonna keep saying. I feel like y'all want you stressed and saying. I don't think this is gonna come back on you like that, dog.
Okay.
I just think it's very goofy. Like this whole thing is goofy. And I think that chick was very extra. And shit. Everybody was in a high and everybody seemed to have like a high energy situation. But like if you was like, you know what I mean, so but if ain't no bullshit, you gonna do it next year?
Yeah.
Everybody say let's end this bitch on a positive note at least. Fuck, man.
What brought you back this year as opposed to like the first year? Like I know you said you wish that you had been working on it and scratching your muscles, but like what made you wanna do it this year?
Oh, I mean, I always want to do it, and then I guess really, I wanted to kind of stretch it a little bit, man. Like I knew, I didn't know Chris wasn't gonna be there. That's something that kind of came out later. I mean, basically, really, the whole crew was gonna be there, so I was like, well, this is an opportunity. I'm not gonna miss like it. It's like a guaranteed time where we have everybody in the same spot kind of working on the same project. And then we kind of use that momentum to move into something else. It's like, yeah, just it was kind of a no-brainer for me.
Real.
And, so you're getting the scripts together this year, though, huh?
Oh, yeah. Like, like just kind of working, like, sort of seeing what we could. Because, like, here's the thing, man. I'll say that our movie isn't the most polished. But, like, for me, I dug it. I really dug the extended cut, and I really wish I could have put everything in that bitch, right? Then like, now. It would have been, like, a 10-minute movie, you dig? But, like,
We have a whole sound issue that we didn't know happened because of the last crash.
Bro, it's at the point now where I haven't watched it all the way through yet.
Oh, like, I was mad.
I'm nervous as a motherfucker.
Oh, I
was. Like, you know, so.
We watched it back. Everything was going okay, I guess. Because there's a few things that, like I said, I wish we had these more hours. Because I wanted to, like, add some things and shit. And when I saw we was at time. But.
We had music and stuff. Like once again, shout out. Like, couldn't put it in there. Because we couldn't make a decision. First, we had a download issue. And, like, everything kept showing up as a text file. And they're sending it from their phones, but like they sent me four other tracks from their phones, and that came up as audio files. For some reason, it just wouldn't.
It's the fuckery of that last. That's just the fuckery of it, bro. Yeah.
And then they had something specific for like a scene that really, well, you actually did still make it in the movie, but you know, we couldn't use the music for. So there's no music in the whole fucking movie at all.
We said this last year, Marty.
What?
And it applies to all of us, bro.
What's that?
We said it last year. You gotta have an editor that ain't you.
Did we say that?
We did.
No. I mean that was the plan originally.
Even the discrepancy I was saying when me and Five had to crash. Mm. The editor ain't crashing. We could have crashed them for 5 hours, and they could have just kept it going from the list editing. Like, you got to have, like, that's brought back to the delegation of jobs. Because the thing is, when you wear all them fucking hats, one of them going to eventually freaking suffocate you, dog, like, and riot. Like,
you going to conk out. Like, I'll die.
And like you said, editing ain't your biggest forte, but if you had a nigga to do it, it would have just moved much faster, and you could have got to all the things. That's why everybody's job is so important. Like, you need... Yeah. A person for each job. Like, even if you know, it's just better, especially in a high power situation. I mean, high power, in a high pressure.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Because that's what it just sounds like, bruh.
Yeah, it
would have gave you most cushion.
It would have. It definitely would have, man. I mean, like, the credits got thrown up there, man. Never really messed with text inside of Premiere before, so like that was a whole new thing. I'm like kind of learning on the fly, like okay, how do I make it roll? How do I make it do that or whatever? Like, I don't even know what it came out like.
It used to be way simpler, I guess, with new functions and shit. They just it's tucked in the side, dog. It's under legacy title, and then once you click it, it's this little banner at the top. It used to say something. Now it's just a marker.
Oh, you can use that now as a title role.
Yeah. Like the things that you make, the monster. If you like made that as a text thing, right up top to the left, there's a thing that says crawl, scroll, or still, and you put it on roll.
Oh, man, I wish I would have fucking known that.
And then that makes it switch from being like something that you write on to something that's on roll.
I put a fucking like I went into the. I don't know what the controls were with that, because I just started fucking with it, but there's a whole bunch of templates.
Yeah.
Yeah, that you can sort of animate, and I used that, and it was.
I mean, before in the past, what we attempted to do was try to make it on iMovie and then just like make that a quick little like MP4 or whatever the fuck.
Yeah, just insert it into whatever. Yeah. But
that's the way.
That's the way.
Especially if you don't know. You know what I mean? Because nobody's really like looking at the high quality definition of your fucking credits.
Right.
Like, especially scrolling words. Like, if you was trying to do something over the movie, then yeah, you got to figure out how to make that happen right fast. But just some shit for people to see. Yeah.
I'm going to just be mad watching it back at the premiere, dog. They got this one scene in particular, bruh, where when we played it every other time, you can hear Jessica's lines. And when we played it that last time for the version that they got, them bitches ain't there, yo.
Yeah, that happened to us last year. We couldn't. The whole last scene we had was just, like, and we had spent all this time waiting on it, too, and it just, something happened in the rendering where we just...
Son.
Yeah, you can't hear a word.
I keep dropping lighters. If I'd have known we had that 30 minutes, though.
Probably could have.
You hear me? But this is all experiences, dog. Gotta learn from every last one of them, dog. Like, it's gonna make us better filmmakers and everything else, man. But we gotta get out here, man. Lawrence talked that shit. He's like, well, y'all about to get on that bitch and just freaking talk forever. And I was like, dog, it's decompressed mode, son.
Yeah, man.
People need to do it. This is a freaking experience.
Light is a perception. It's not really a true thing.
That's your tagline? Mm-hmm. I'm just start going off saying that light is perception. It's not a true thing. So it's time. But anyway.
Nah, I was just saying that like for the best thing for the movie, because like I haven't seen your film, but definitely looking at the stuff we shot and then like working with Keith from Comfy Stones. Like,
big ups.
You know, once you really start that like them lofty ass film things, like when they start to be like karate kung fu make sense for you, that's when you like, all right, I've ascended another level, because then it's going to reflect in your work.
Right.
Like, it ain't just gonna be this big ass statement. Like, I said it like that before, nigga. That no, he nodded. You know what I mean? Yeah. So I'm doing the fucking Illuminati shout out before we go.
And shout out to Devontae. That had nothing to do with what you just said, Five. That was some deep shit. That was real. But I just wanted to shout out. He was like one of our newer team members this year. And like, you're just a real cool dude. Like, you know what I mean? You know, sometimes you never worked with someone before. You don't know what their temperaments will be.
Right, right. Yeah. We had a, I think her name was Kristen, I think. I don't want to say it wrong. But we had a new member too. Or at least somebody who kind of showed up. And it happened to be because we needed to shoot that scene out. That's actually why we didn't use Trina. That probably would have been Trina, had she had been there. But it was like we had to, you know, kind of move. Which,
yeah.
You know, shout out to the Rogue Martians, though. I mean, everybody like committed like an amazing amount of time to us, and it's just, I really wish we had more time. That it was just a better thing that would have shown up at the screening. But
yeah. I wish y'all could see my dog face.
I'm just I need more time, man. But like, man. And then, man, the way it was, it's like, yeah, the scene, man. I just wish I could have shown the extended cut or something like that. But I guess there'll be life for that later on.
I mean, it will be. I hope I can finally see it. I don't know what happened to your last movie. Never saw that.
Oh, bro, that one I gotta find it. Like when I got a new phone, it kind of went away. I don't.
I mean, we all gonna see each other both though, whatever cuts.
Yeah, that's gonna be cool. We're gonna be in the same screening for the first time.
These whatever cuts.
That's I'm not excited to see your film, but like the films that will be in attendance with ours are gonna be like, man, what the fuck.
No, son, don't do that. We talked about this every time. You already know from experience your damn self, Marty. There's always a good, like, three that's, like, you know, really good.
Yeah.
Maybe good two or three that's really bad. Right. And everything else just kind of falls in the middle where they kind of fall, honestly.
Which I would, oh, man, I gotta watch it.
Man, I feel the struggle of the 48 dog, but I think, like, when it's, like, I don't know, good or just other. It's like when you really try to push the medium or like really pimp the fuck out of like what you do. Like, you know what I mean? So if it's on VHS, you going hard as fuck on VHS. If it's claymation, you going hard on claymation. Mm-hmm. Like long as you do that, you should be like the true winner. You know what I mean? Instead of it being, I had the glossier shots or some other shit, or I had the famous or actor, or I don't know how that worked in the short film thing, but you know what I'm saying? Like, it should really just be like how I felt it. Like, you know, was I moved? Did that shit really hit the notes? Boom, boom, boom.
Right.
I mean, technical shit counts too, because they do score you on that. But overall, really being like, is it what's up? Like, because when Diggory Doo had one key flipping, like, they did some, like, cheesy cardboard cereal thing. And it was whack. It was like, it wasn't even like they gave it depth. It was like, nigga, it's whack and we know it's whack. And then that shit kind of won.
Nah. Them people didn't think their thing was whack.
All right, excuse me.
You thought their thing was whack.
Whatever, man.
They made it very simply and very cheaply, but that was part of the, like, what they wanted to do. That was part of the joke.
The aesthetic.
The aesthetic.
I mean?
And a lot of people did like it, but it was, like, not hit our particular... Because the thing is, I wasn't into it, but I caught the humor of it. He just hated the shit.
They had the color and the vibe,
it was so unique.
But no substance.
It was so unique. You know what I'm saying? Like, they're like, they said cardboard cutouts for a spaceship. You know what I mean? They're going intentionally cheesy. And it worked to their advantage because it was so tongue-in-cheek. So, like, you got to come at how you come at it, man. So, anybody, listen, if you want to do the 48-hour film project, hopefully, like, this could help. Just like I always say, on acting while black. Learn from experiences. Learn from our fuck-ups and the things that we do right. You dig? We have a screening coming up. You can find our joints on Gubble Monster 504 on YouTube. Rogue Martians, y'all got a YouTube page yet?
We do have a YouTube page. I didn't realize we had one. But, I don't know if it's Rogue Martians or not. I have to check into that. But for now, I guess you can just search Rogue Martians on YouTube. And there should be, like, there's just, like, a couple of sketches. And I want to say... Yeah, just the first film's up there, not the second one, because I remember us watching that. But first film from the first 48 that we did is up, which I'm still extremely proud of.
So you dug your first one, and this one you suspect on.
This one, because of like what had to be cut out of it, man, nah, I'm not so in love with it. But there's a couple of things in there where I'm like, okay, well, you know what? This looks good. This looks like... Like, you figured it out at this point. It's too bad that was kind of toward the end. But, you know, hey, it's cool.
Got an interesting... with our film, I just feel like the film that I wanted to do in my head is not it.
Yeah.
So it's like...
Kind of, yeah.
If people like it, fine. If people don't like it, fine. But, like, this story, how I really want to tell it, is not what people are going to see, and it's not even what we fully shot.
Well, for you know me, if saying? I'm
so it's, that's gonna be the bittersweet thing for me yeah. in watching it.
I think honestly, or at least what I take away from this is that this was just sort of a wake up call that
I take that.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Like we can really, really do this. And everybody's committed, everybody's down to do it. We don't need the 48-hour film festival to do this.
Right.
So you know what I'm saying? Like we can actually kind of sit down and really polish some shit up and then go out and shoot that too, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
So it's just kind of like, well, you know, I take it as if we had been shooting things like we said we would, if mm-hmm. I had kind of kept the promises that I did, then we would have had a little bit more stuff under our belt. But like, this is sort of that first thing. Like, say if we had encountered a couple of things editing wise, like mm-hmm. that I kind of ran into this time around, I could have, you know, applied that to this time going around. But it's right. like everything, I guess now we sort of take everything as a lesson. That's basically what this one
I mean,
was just a re
even your good game. Projects are lessons. They all
yeah,
lessons.
Yeah, true.
Every
true.
Time we do any of these things, it's gonna be a lesson, whether it's the winner or not. So hell yeah, dog. Well, let's yeah. get up out here, man. Yeah. What we gonna review next? We got Euphoria to do.
Hold on, wait, are we doing
sign-offs? Yeah, but get out of here. But I'm just saying what you're about to do for
no, you guys did, and I was just like, oh, I just wanted to say bye, too.
We didn't say bye at all yet.
Oh,
we didn't say bye at all yet. I just asked this man what's coming out.
Any interest in
movies? I'm trying to think of anything coming out.
Once Upon a Time in Hollywood?
I really do want to see that.
Okay, that's out now.
I am a Stubbs member. I can just go. Mm-hmm. Oh, that's a thing. Well, that looks like it's coming up. We're going to do Euphoria. We're going to do Once Upon a Time in Hollywood. Peanut, if you're listening, please
Hobbs
let us know.
Hobbs and Stubbs comes on Friday.
Hobbs and who?
Stubbs.
Hobbs and Shaw.
Shaw.
Oh, this yeah. Friday. Mm-hmm. So those are two options.
It was what you said it was.
I want to see both of those. Mm-hmm. I think Hobbs and Shaw going to be fun.
Hobbs and Stubbs, you mean?
All that. I hope I get some Stubbs off. But yeah, man, we about to get up out of here. Mr. That Actor Guy, Mr. Bats in the building, man. Follow me at Mr. Bats. Spell it Mr. Audio. You ain't gonna find me as usual. Well, reviewing that.
Oh! I saw it too late. I'm sorry.
Damn, it's okay. It comes on. But like, yeah, hit us up at. I wonder where to record it. That actor guy, Mr. Bats. You can find me at Mr. Bats. Spell it, Mr. Otter. You ain't gonna find me as usual. Hit us up at ReviewingDAT@gmail.com. You refer it, we review it. We got more to come. And yeah, man, thanks for listening to us. You know, jibber jabber about our experience. Tell them niggas where to find y'all.
Oh, you can find me, Marty, Marty Edwards, 504 on Instagram, Twitter, and Snap at the chat. Also, go to LorainPictures.com. Click on the Your30 tab where I co-host the show there with. What's his name?
Black Actopedia.
The Black Actopedia, also known as The Arrogant Observer. Your 30 with Marty and The Arrogant Observer. Check it out. Marty's out.
That's what's up, man. I said no one less. But what up, well, for the last time, man. This is DJ Mike5, also known as Father 5. And, you know, shouts out to Kelly and the people. I really thank them for Max Ash and LEP for letting me take some time out to make a movie and to come kick it with their uncle. Or you're not their uncle, but that's... Yeah, you know I mean, but yeah, hopefully we see y'all on some pitches moving forward.
Why'd you say?
Because I was looking at.
You're not. I mean, not you. Yeah, actual uncle over here.
I like you.
Like that nigga.
Thank
you.
Know
nigga. I'm just trying to spread love.
Nah, man.
Like, you know, ownership.
I always, you know. Shout out to the Rogue Martians, man. Thank y'all for giving up all of your time and sacrificing with us. Oh, man. We're going to do more.
Yeah, the monster. Wonder. Do 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 do
doodle 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 doodle